All right. Anyway, so no snow in the New York area. So there you go.
Steve was panicking.
Yeah, I know.
Panicking.
Well, that's why Patrice is here.
Panic. I've never seen anyone panic about
I like to say thank you for having me here by mistake. I always like to hang out.
Steve, he was in such a panic. He's like, what if you don't make it in? I'm like, why don't you just like call somebody? Well, and if I make it, who can't? We're all here.
Yeah.
It's a different mindset when Norton is here and you're here.
Yeah.
And really? When Norton is not here and you're here.
Right.
Because there's no, you almost got to, you feel, you're taking your place as opposed to, like, I'm standing here this morning talking and getting built up to be you today. And then you come in and go, shut up. And I'm like, who's that? And I'm like, I thought Norton was gone.
Yeah.
That's why I'm here.
So now you can just coast and hang out and have fun.
You can still be you.
Barely.
Shut up.
Barely.
It's a different.
We like you.
There's a seven o'clock mentality when you're here and it's a 6 a.m.
Basically, Patrice knows his place when you're here.
Yeah, it's a position.
That's what you're saying. Yeah. He knows his place.
Well, I don't want to say it as slavey as that, but I mean, I'm just saying, it's just, you know, it's a different mentality. It's a 4:45 mentality as opposed to a 6 o'clock.
By the way, some guy in Connecticut saying I'm plowing snow right now. We're not talking
about
you in particular. We got Boston calls coming in. They got lots of snow up there. All schools closed last night here. Still no plows out. So Boston, it's a different story. We're talking about our perspective here in New York, how ridiculous these weather people are.
They pounded this thing like it was going to be a foot of snow, stand still,
right?
And not going to be able to get to work.
We're live in Boston. There's a difference between Boston and New York when it comes to weather too. We don't get as much snow as Boston. So when they're telling you it's going to snow, it's kind of a big deal down here. I mean, we lived in Boston. I mean, there's blizzards and nor'easters, and everyone's just driving to the mall because they can.
Yeah.
They're just used to it a little bit more than us down here. Let's go to John. What's up, John?
Hey, what's up, guys? How you doing?
Hey.
Yeah, well, I work for the sanitation department. They went crazy last night for no reason. It was on and off. They didn't know what was going on.
Yeah, well, you guys don't follow the local weather guy, do you?
Well, we have our own weather department, which is pretty accurate.
Right.
But last night was crazy.
All right. Thank you, sir.
Well, all right. No, great
there's
show.
Nothing. Thank you. Jimmy, what's up?
I just got a note from Steve. I'll happily take the panicky Pete beating instead of the Steve's a douche beating.
Well, how about he's got both? A choice. Steve, the panicky Pete douche.
Yeah. Well, no, Jimmy went to see, Diana Ross last night?
Oof. Yes.
And that's why we thought you weren't going to make it.
Fabulous.
All the way down there in Atlantic City with a big snowstorm hitting the East Coast. We're like, I don't think Jimmy's going to make it in today.
She was...
You went... That's why you was in Atlantic City?
Yes, I was working in Pennsylvania, and I'm like, I'm an hour and a half from this. Of course, I like Diana Ross, so I wanted to go see her. So we went down to...
Do you really like Diana Ross, or were you hoping to get a picture?
I didn't even try to get a picture. I didn't call the promoter or anything.
You really didn't try to get a picture?
You would always want a picture, but I made no effort.
Right.
No, I love
Diana Ross. I was convinced when I heard you were going to go see Diana Ross. I'm like, he just wants a picture.
Matt. I like her, but not enough to on a school night go down to 2.5 hours away.
Right, right.
They should start making film with Norton already in it. Just when you take a picture and Norton's just in, he's just in a picture already. He just has a picture of everybody.
I didn't get it though with her. I didn't try to.
No.
Why?
Because I'm not gonna get that's backstage. I'm not involved in her world. I don't know anybody she knows. But
and you bought a ticket or you called in a favor?
They gave me one because I'm there next week. So they were cool. They gave me a room and a ticket. And
did you really like the concert?
Amazing. She was. I can't tell. It's like a rock concert.
You
she's an animal. She's almost 70 years old.
You're a
gay man.
Like Beyonce.
She cannot dance for any. And she's got the only gay people in the world who can't dance are her fans. The worst dancing people on the entire planet. Right.
It's
there.
One
all
big.
Gay.
What is it? A 2-hour sing along? Because I mean. Is there one song she actually sings where people don't know the words?
Like two new ones, maybe. But aside from that,
stupid new song.
You was by yourself?
Nah, I went with my girlfriend, and we fought all day, and we didn't speak for 7 hours. So we both were sitting there watching a legend. It was like Flight of the Conchords. Like nobody looks at each other. We were all just kind of staring straight ahead in alternative fashion. It was really irritating.
So you guys didn't even make up before the concert?
No.
Are you still fighting?
Probably, yeah.
What happened?
We just don't get along anymore. It's not even...
Anymore?
No. You guys were in love last week.
I'm saying, like, I even said to her, like, as much as I'd like to blame it all on her, it's like I know that she's not so completely nuts that she's 100% wrong. It's just we just miss each other. It's
right.
It's one of those things where we just pass each other. I don't know how it happened. So, but the concert was lovely, and I got a little bit of camera footage of gay people dancing.
They
need rock concert security because they were running right up to the stage and just taking pictures of her, and the guy's like, "Can I kind of go back?"
Right.
You know, at rock concerts, they grab you and throw you out.
Oh yeah, right really on your annoying. Ass.
Huh. So, a bunch of gay people and us. It was nice.
And a long ride back to New York without talking?
Well, not talking pleasantly.
Oh, really?
That was awful.
Just nipping at each other? Nip.
Or full-fledged argument?
Hey, Norton, how come you don't exercise your better-than-her muscles more often?
I you can't do it in a relationship. I mean, your friends can tell you to do that, but in a relationship, you're like, you know how it is, man. You're like, it was just... I don't know. I wanted to punch the windshield out. I told her that. I'm like, I want to punch drama.
I can't do it anymore.
I can't do it anymore.
You just like drama. Just stop.
I don't like drama. I'm too old. I'm 40.
You do like drama. You're arguing with. You're better than that. You're selling out the Borgata next week, and you're having a punch the window argument. Like, what is the matter with you?
Well, I wasn't arguing with my agent.
But that's what I'm saying. You're like, gosh darn it. Why don't you, Jimmy, you know, explaining life to your girl? Is just
Jimmy geez. Likes being in love.
He does.
He wants a girlfriend. And he takes it very seriously. So
we all do, but...
No, you don't. You're in your
I
own
absolutely
world.
Absolutely.
You're from another planet.
Seriously. He does in his own way.
But yeah, I do. I do take it seriously. Just I hate to see suffering.
Yeah.
Especially when Norton is like selling out the place with Diana Ross. Are you performing in the same place she was?
No, I did that room with Attell. We did one show there. No, I'm doing the music box. She did the events.
Yeah. But you're still doing. So it's the difference between the Madison Square Garden with 25,000 and the other one. It's it's still major.
It's a great gig.
I mean, it's still Atlantic City, the
Jimmy's,
Vegas of the
Jimmy's
East Coast.
Downplaying. It's a big room, man.
Yeah,
and he sold out three shows down there.
Yeah, but Miss Ross had one big
show. Miss Ross, you call her.
She's wonderful, man.
How does that one woman sneak into... I'm always curious about that. How does the one woman sneak into the like, you guys are famous and Norton's famous. How does that one girl be the one when it's so many? How does that one end up the one that's your woman that you're going to deal with all the nonsense? You know what I'm saying? Like, I know my girl. I'm like that. Because she hung around so long. You know, she's just there.
She's just there.
She wouldn't go. You know what I mean? But how does...
The key is to find one that's where there's no nonsense, Patrice. Or less nonsense.
I have nonsense. It's like I can't
have nonsense.
But I don't have nonsense.
But how does she squeeze in to... How does she squeeze in?
She's the funniest person honestly, she makes me laugh. She's guy funny. I honestly can tell you.
She's really
she
funny.
She really makes
you
me
gotta
laugh.
Give her credit. She is really
she
funny.
Really?
Dude, she makes
just
me laugh.
Just hanging out, she's a funny girl, man.
Really hard. Like, and not polite, my girlfriend laughs, but like, for real, laughs.
Really?
Like, yeah. And that was what we became friends for 3 years. We were friends for a long time, so.
Yeah.
Are you friends for a minute?
She was one of my best friends, yeah, for a long time.
For a minute.
Hey, okay.
Hey, Jimmy, I also heard that you might have had a dream last night. Or was it two nights ago?
I told Steve, remind me. I had a dream that I had a threesome. This is the absolute truth with her and Tom Chiasano.
What does that mean?
First of all, that's not a threesome. You and Tom Chiasano pull the train on your girl. Holy moly.
Quickly, for the newbies, Tom Chiasano, he's 60, he's the GM of the station here in New York City, worked a very long time with Howard Stern, and you had a threesome in your dream.
I bet he had his Tom suit Chiasano. Jacket, all his suit tops, his tie, and everything was on, just his pants was off, but he had his tie and everything else.
I just picture the scene from Office Space with Lundberg, like having sex with the guy's girlfriend that he met over at the restaurant. Yeah, holding her ankles and drinking coffee. Yeah. Hey, are those TPS reports in? And they're showing him just kind of banging her.
I wish I had a better. It was a very brief dream. It was. Let's just say
you don't need a better story. That alone is.
You was playing Ring Around the Rosie with
No, we didn't.
Tom.
All we did was this. She in the dream. Let's say she was laying on her back. Tom was doing something. Let's just say he was making her feel very good, and I was kissing her, and that was the whole dream.
You was being loving while old Tom was smashing the yams?
Yeah, and he kept talking to her like in boring, like regular guy talk, like, all right, I'm going to do this right now, and he was just like talking like we're talking right now, and it was nothing sexy about it.
Did he make her do commercial reads?
Did he wipe his mouth with his tie?
Oh, my God. Oh. Why would you dream that? What kind of Freudian something is that?
I don't know.
Did he try to figure out how he could bring a sponsor into the whole situation?
Oh.
You know, we could sponsor this.
Did he push the dump button?
Oh. It looked like a lemon party with one chick.
Didn't that wake you up, though? There are dreams that happen where I wake up instantly.
Wake up like it's in the movies.
I don't want to. Somehow my brain knows I don't want to deal with this, and I wake up instantly.
I don't remember what woke me up, but it was that was as far as the sex went. Was he was doing that, and I was making out with her, and then I wish I could remember more of what he was saying in the dream, because it was completely mechanical sexual stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah, it wasn't sexy
at
all.
That's so odd.
Yeah.
Get on with this. I got to golf at 12.
Yeah.
Exactly. Stuff like that.
Get on with it.
It was quick.
Or making golf innuendo jokes about your girl. There's quite a few you can use, you know. Grab his putter.
Oh, God.
Something about the 18th hole.
Norton looks disturbed by that, too. Like, he looks like he's thinking about why did he actually had that dream about that.
Well, he's going to yell at her now.
Huh?
I wonder if I'm a cuckold.
You're a dream cuckold.
Do bring up that word a lot, Jimmy. I never knew the word until I started hanging out with you, so.
I've been kind of liking those movies.
The dream cuckold, da 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 da.
You know what a cuckold, you know what a cuckold is, right? Where you get, kind of sit there and watch your girl get, railed, basically, by somebody else.
Yeah, I know what a cuckold is.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Jimmy has
brought that to attention. I didn't know what it was, but.
Yeah.
Without you getting any action.
Wait,
right?
So you sit there and you watch these type of, films?
Lately I have been, yeah.
What, cuckold film?
Are they believable? Because I would imagine a lot of those are just.
Some are. A lot of times.
How do you know they're believable?
Well, just because I think that the way the girl's reacting to the guy, like if it's a hardcore film by actors, it doesn't do anything for me.
Right.
But when it's an average looking girl and just the guy who's packing,
yeah.
To me, I like that because that's like a girl who's like humiliating her husband. It's like a lot of times a guy just sits there and all she's doing is talking to the guy. She's like, what a real man. It's like, I like the girl acting like such a slut.
Here comes Hot Pants right here.
There he is.
Is it kind of, look at that. Is it kind of creepy to see?
Yeah, is it weird to look at him now after that
dream? Look where the mic started at.
Tom Chiasano.
Yeah.
Was there anything that stimulated this, or was it?
I don't know what happened. It was weird, but it was a very brief thing, and it was only that. I just woke up right after that, and I told her about it. We kind of had a laugh about it.
I bet it's nine.
Does Tom look good naked?
She didn't. No, he wasn't. He, honest to God, was dressed. He was dressed like that.
Of course he would.
Yeah, with his pants, just his pants off.
Right.
And my
not even his pants off, just a zipper down.
Just a zipper down.
Yeah.
And that old man, eight coming out.
Oh, Jesus.
Just that Viagra 8.
I think what Jimmy was describing, though.
By the way, it's an old man 9.
I bet it is.
I think what Jimmy was describing, though, was the fact that that wasn't even being used.
No, not
right?
at all. Not at
yeah.
all.
Tom was doing stuff where perhaps his braces would have had to have been cleaned out afterwards. That's all.
Yeah, it was very, very,
taking care of business.
Calling you young fella.
Young fella.
And you're just sitting there watching.
I was just kissing her. I don't know what it means. Honest to God, that's the whole dream.
Wow.
Nothing else happened. You and I certainly didn't interact.
That's your God.
There was none of that, like, do you really want your job stuff happening?
No, it basically means you would sacrifice your girl for a raise. It's
I bet you that is my psychology-wise, I bet you.
Definitely something like that going on.
Yeah. She didn't know who Tom, she's like, Tom, do I meet him? And she's like, was he the guy that we went out with? I'm like, no, that was Eric Logan. I'm sure they'll be like, you know,
yeah.
The murder right. happens. I'm sure he'll be banging him in a dream.
You just want Tom, you want Tom to notice you. I analyze dreams. I'm a dream reader now. I'm not, but
oh, you are.
But you just want Tom to notice you, no matter what.
Oh, maybe that's it. Yeah, a little more recognition.
Look, Jimmy, one vision. I notice Jimmy all the time.
Thank you. They call me the live read kid.
Yes.
All right, Tom.
Well,
thank you
for including me in your after work life.
Thank you for doing a good job on her.
How about those Rangers, Tom? Huh? Islanders are on a little roll, my man. I should have taken that bet.
Tom's music is hilarious. The dead people.
Oh, it's just all now taps and just, funeral music.
Let me bring everyone on board. Tom.
Terrible.
Tom thinks we need more sounds on this show. So there you go. He gets his special sounds every time he comes in now. All right, we got to take a break.
Boards are not enough?
No.
We got to take a break. Listen, we're going to talk some football after the break. Patrice's Pats won, of course. Jimmy's Cowboys lost. Eli's not playing football. He's done for the year. So we'll do a little bit on that. What else? Oh, Anthony's gambling, of course. We'll
Eli,
do that.
Who?
Yes.
What are you talking about?
Eli's out.
No,
Peyton's out. Yeah. I'm sorry. It's early. Yeah, Peyton's the. Who would have thought that Eli would still be playing and Peyton would be sitting at this point? All right, we'll talk about Anthony's gambling. He did a big weekend at Mohegan Sun. There's a bunch of other things. We got to look at the show. Oh, OJ and yeah. All right, we're just getting started. Stay there. It's Opie and Anthony. At our old gig when we were doing afternoon drive, one of our biggest advertisers was Paisano's of Mulberry Street. And Tom, relax. He sold the restaurant, so we're not trying to promote his restaurant. I don't even know who owns it anymore. He moved out of that of Little Italy over a year ago. But before we started doing all that great advertising for Joey, he was pretty much in bed with Scott and Todd here in New York City.
Yeah.
And they actually filmed a TV commercial.
Mm-hmm.
And I guess Joey must have put it up on YouTube. He must have.
Yeah.
It's up there, and we're going to link it to onaradio.com later today.
It's so bad.
We didn't know what to say when we saw it. We were very uncomfortable.
Yeah, I had no words.
I don't want to be friends with Joey anymore after seeing this commercial.
Joey does not look like Joey.
No, no. No, not at all.
And they're all doing these bad, like, Italian stereotypes.
Yeah.
It's really horrid.
By the way,
just horrible.
If you don't want to wait for us to link it up later on onaradio.com, it's Scott. You throw Scott and Todd starring Joey's Paisano into YouTube and you'll find it.
Look at Joey.
Look at Joey. Oof. It's a bigger Joey. A much bigger Joey.
With the glasses?
Yeah. That was
like
Joey.
It's like Jerry Lewis after the steroids.
Yeah.
Yeah, where he blew up.
All right. Hey, speaking of the big snowstorm here in New York that didn't happen. Sam did a great job. He put this together. Basically, this is what they were saying last night on the local news.
Well, as we said, snow and rain are falling across the tri-state, and some schools have already posted delays and closings for tomorrow. You'll see those along the bottom of your screen there. Well, right now, Erica Tarantell is in North Bergen with more on how people spent the day preparing for this storm.
Expect the morning ride to look very different from this late-night drive. What's wet is forecast to be white.
There's no question about it. Tomorrow morning is not going to be an easy commute. It's going to be snow, slush, speed limits probably reduced on the turnpike to about 45 miles an hour.
Yeah.
Is it?
And
really? I was doing 80 on the expressway.
And this is what they're saying this morning.
Well, I tell you what, we were fired up. I'm not going to kid you. We thought we were going to get it this time, and the storm, it disappointed all of us, especially the children. Now, some of them, of course, are gone in a little bit late today, but temperatures, that was an issue. Let's walk and talk, and we'll break it down for you and tell you what our issues were. Among them, the storm never really picked up in intensity, and when it arrived here, well, it was this soggy out there. The temperature's just too warm. Now, you know,
and I'll say it again. You know, this is on purpose. They probably knew late last night or sometime after the football games that this storm wasn't going to have the punch.
I know.
But they don't want you to stop watching their news channel.
No.
That's the problem with the news. That's why you can't really call it the news anymore. Just call it, like, entertainment BS.
Call it newsertainment.
Yeah. You want another example? We got plenty of them. Here's what they were saying last night on another station.
Mm-hmm.
Road crews in New Jersey and New York City prepped early in the day for the storm moving in.
We're ready to go out with 1,400 plows tonight throughout the city, along with our over 350 soil spreaders.
Shoppers in South Hackensack were also ready to go. Some grabbed a movie, others extra groceries in case the snow means an extra day off.
In case we get stuck inside the house and not able to work.
Inside.
So we're stacking up, ready to cook.
What year
and your
is
best
this?
Bet getting
is
to work on time tomorrow is leaving plenty of extra time. Also, crews want to remind all drivers to leave extra room for the salt spreaders and the plow trucks
yes.
so they can do their work safely.
Yeah, well,
they gotta get through that snow.
Have you ever gone to the grocery store or a bodega or a corner, whatever, and got extra groceries because you thought you were going to be stuck inside?
Be snowed in.
I actually throw food out when they see a storm coming.
Right.
Nothing in my house.
Oh, my God. And we're supposed to vote for the next president with these people out there that have to go get groceries because we might get some snow?
Morons.
And then there's what they were saying this morning.
It's great to be here. Thanks so much. I was worried about getting here this morning, but all is well outside.
Yes.
In most parts.
For the most part. It's a little storm that couldn't for the most part as well for most of the tri-state area. North and east of town, there's still a little bit of snow on the ground and some still falling. But for the most part, this was not the heavy hitter in the city. And on south, nothing really. Roads are just wet.
Yeah.
Of course.
Dopes.
Just a bunch of hype.
And they brag about their weather machines.
Yes, the Doppler 9000 Futurecast 400 million.
Yeah, what happened to the Doppler? That you brag about all the time, right?
Doppler's like old news now. They don't even say that anymore.
Because it's just a boring name.
Yeah, so they've come up with even better names, like Forecast 6,000. And
it's just weird numbers after the machine.
Yeah, whatever the machine is, and then big numbers. Make sure that your number is bigger than the other news channel's number, because then you're that much better. Well, it's one more better.
Could they call it like the Infinity Forecaster, Infinity?
Infinity.
Infinity to infinity.
Infinity times infinity.
Yeah.
The Doppler pi squared.
Yeah.
With douches. Imagine how that would change if they fired a whole bunch of weathermen after a night like last night.
They should.
They just fired 40 of them.
No, actually, they probably are going to get raises from the news station.
Yeah.
Because they got people to continue watching their program.
That's all it takes.
That's all it is. It's actually, you would get fired for being the guy going, oh, look, man, I know everyone else is saying it, but I can't lie anymore. I've looked at the Doppler or the Infinity machine, and this is going to be a bust.
Like, what are you doing?
They would fire him right on the spot.
People aren't going to tune in.
So, all right, enough of that. Anthony had the big gambling weekend.
Yes, this was the big weekend that Mohegan Sun was flying us up there.
Well, you took a lot of money from Mohegan, safe to say.
Well,
and
they
kind of wanted their money back, so they offered you, a trip up to Mohegan on them, basically a free ride in a plane.
Yeah, they
limos and all sorts of and suites and all that.
Oh yeah,
basically they think you're a whale.
It was like a rock star.
Yeah,
it's great. Took Keith and his wife and mom and Sal, which is just a rip, because my mom doesn't like flying much at all. And with the smaller plane and the weather the way it was on Friday, probably the worst flying conditions ever. It was JFK Jr. flying conditions where you can't see anything out there. So my mother was, it was like Weekend at Bernie's. She had taken a Valium. The plane was delayed for a little bit. So we went over to that 56 fighter group over there at Republic.
Yeah.
Down to few.
Of course you did.
Down to few. And
why wouldn't you?
So it was pretty much, you know, getting mom on the plane. She was a little...
Why don't you just tell us you were breathing?
A little tipsy. Well,
I love how Anthony brings that to our attention. Like, really? You had a few?
Well, you know, the plane was delayed because the weather.
Well, what else would you do if the plane was delayed?
Well, you're not going to just gonna sit around Republic Airport.
I gotcha.
There's really nothing going on there.
So you had a few. Mom had a Valium.
A little Valium.
Yeah.
And a couple of drinks. So, she was a little, you know, a little loose. A little like, hey, let's get on the plane kind of a thing. And so we all got on the plane. And... The weather was horrific. I mean, it was rain. They had some thunder and lightning.
Can I slow you down for a second?
Yeah.
Because I already know the answer, but I think a bunch of people will laugh at their radios. When we left everybody on Friday, you were getting the private jet to Mohegan Sun.
Right.
I know you didn't get the private jet.
Well, it had two jets in it. It was a turboprop.
With a lot of other whales, too, right?
There were a few. It wasn't like, you know, I had to sit next to people I didn't want to talk to or anything.
Right.
And, they were all going to the same place.
They just picked up all the whales like a bus all over Long Island and brought them to Mohegan Sun.
No. It's a little better than that. It wasn't like hopping on the jitney.
All right.
You know, and it's about a 30-minute flight.
Yeah.
The longest. It's probably 20 minutes. But with the weather the way it was, oh, my God. Oh, was that just a horrific flight. Nothing but turbulence. And then when we go to land, you saw no ground. It was nothing but fog right up until, and I was kind of videotaping out the window just in case, you know, anything happens. I want to make a little record of it.
Yeah, they won't find you, but they'll find your little cheap.
Find a little memory chip.
Maybe.
Say it, they'll find it, plug it in, and go, wow, look at that. You taped his own crash. Death.
Well, you hear the jangle of little, like, airplane liquor bottles.
There wasn't even time for that. It was time for one beer.
This must have been where Anthony was sitting. How do you know that, sir? Well, look at all the empties around.
A lot of empties. The jingle jangle of the vodka bottle. But the plane kind of is coming in for a landing. You feel it. And then you hear him hit the throttle, and we're going back up again. And he comes on and goes, I saw the runway a little too late on that one.
Jesus.
So we're going around it. We're going around again.
You don't want to hear that.
So
Die Hard 2.
It was a very hard, yeah.
Had a guy with a torch.
It was a very long Jesus. Circle that he took. I think he was waiting for the clouds to break up a little and gave it another try. So we start descending again and didn't even get close this time. Back up again.
Now
he doesn't even go to the radio.
Is there anything more horrifying than being in a plane and having no clue as you look out the window, you see nothing?
It was, we didn't know where we were.
Does anyone else just picture mountains?
It was white.
In front of you?
Yes, the giant Rockies of Connecticut.
Well, whatever. I don't even care if
it could be an antenna or something.
If we're over the ocean and you see nothing when you look out the window, I'm convinced there's going to be some huge sea monster that's popping his head up and you're going to...
I was saying that if you're at 35,000 feet and something goes bad and you're just spiraling in and you have time to text friends and actually get a response back and, you know, take care of some last minute business, fill out a will as you're plummeting, that's one thing. If you're in fog during a landing and you hit something, I'm pretty much from the school of thought it's over pretty quickly.
Pretty fast.
You're just like, you're flying, you're looking out the window, bam, it's over. Bam, the old beyond, whatever happens after this, that's it, that's what's happening.
Stop seeing Ghost of Buddy Holly and that's Big Bopper.
Yeah, that's a Big Bopper.
Hello, Anthony.
Hello, Anthony. Flew too low, baby. The plane came in too slow, baby.
Glass in your face.
Hello.
Hello, baby. The clouds are too low, babe. Oh, you know what I like, a runway.
Oh, man.
That's pretty much what it was.
Oh, man.
So the second approach, he
missed that one.
A little
go around. And now it's a real long approach. I think he's lining up pretty far out because we went back out over the Long Island Sound and came back again. And this 25-minute flight is now an hour. We're an hour in the air. And I have a video clip of this. I'm looking out the window, and it's nothing but pea soup clouds. You see the prop going. And from the time we broke through the clouds to the time we actually landed was 30 seconds. It was 30 seconds from the time he saw nothing till he saw the runway, make sure you lined up, gear down, flaps down, hit the runway hard and fast. And then just, and everyone on the plane.
Of course.
Did the applause.
Of course you got it.
They applauded the pilot.
Still alive.
Yeah.
What a dumb thing to do. Oh, I'm alive.
Hey, thank you. Thank you. We live. We live another day. And then, the whole thing with Republic is a little odd too. I just want to say to any terrorists listening, Republic Airport would be the place you want to go because no checks whatsoever. No security. Can they please do something with Republic? I understand they're commuter planes, but some of these planes carry like 30 people.
Ah, what are they going to do? Take out a brownstone?
No, that could do some damage. It could absolutely do some damage.
Yeah.
And then we're flying back. And the cockpit door is open. The whole flight.
Yeah.
It's just open.
It was lonely.
There's people with carry-on that has not been checked at all. No one looked at it. It went through no machine. Nothing. You just get on this plane. It's a little odd to me.
They just know it wouldn't do much damage. That's what it comes down to.
Is that what it is?
Yes. That's exactly what it is.
I think that thing full of fuel could probably do a lot of damage.
The government doesn't think so. They don't really care about your life.
30 hostages?
And they'll let 30 hostages be beheaded, the government.
Yeah?
Yes! That's how it works.
It's a little creepy.
Government would pretty much be, sucks. Sucks to be you guys. I don't know what to tell you. I'm serious. Got to make a big splash.
Yeah.
If you're a terrorist. Little stuff like that, government's like, yeah, whatever.
Yeah, maybe that's why they didn't, but I don't know.
So how was the gambling?
Well, let me tell you. Day one, sat down, broke out about 10 G's to start with, and built it up to $70,000.
Wow.
Yeah, that was a good one.
First day, you're up 60 G's?
Yeah.
Wow.
Which I promptly lost. And
same day?
Same session.
Same session?
Yeah. They really turned it around on me.
Why would
it around. Because I was gunning for 100, okay? I wasn't going to stop at 70.
I know my question is really stupid. That's why I don't think I have the gambling bug in me, because there's a point where I just, you know what, I walk.
What point? 20,000? 30,000?
You just feel 40? You just feel like, wow, this is kind of nice.
I wasn't feeling it. It felt good. I was going for 100.
And that's what the casino banks on.
Going for 100.
If you were at 70, like when you went backwards, like why wouldn't you go, or I just dropped, like gave them 20 or 25 back and then go from there? Like that's a lot.
No, because then you win it back plus more.
Okay.
See, this is what they depend on. That's what the casino
depends. Have you made up your mind that once you lost all the money, all the gambling money that you've been gambling with,
mm-hmm.
you go, I'm done.
No.
Of course not.
I wasn't done. I got it back.
When you lose it all, are you ready to quit? Are you going to go into your own savings after you lose
gambling money? No savings, no. No.
But I'm saying your money.
Oh, if it's all gone like that?
Like this gambling
at
money.
At some point, then I'd have to. I'm not going to stop, you know, going to casinos, but... You know. Why?
I thought your whole thing was like, I'm going to bet with this money.
Yeah, yeah.
And that was what I'm going to do. Like, had a pride to bet with that money. But mm-hmm. if that money goes, you're not going to stop. You're still going to bet.
Yeah, you're going to get the money from somewhere.
Oh, I took more than 10 with me.
No, I understand that. What Patrice is saying, you kind of made it obvious to everybody that you're playing off money you might have won.
Right.
So when you lose all that money, because you will.
Yeah.
You're going to continue gambling.
Yeah, then what? I'm never supposed to go to a casino again?
But you're saying you're not going to take it out of your savings.
Oh, I have to. Where else am I going to get it?
All right, there you go.
Yeah. No, but
you're what?
When does it end?
I don't know. When I'm broke and destitute?
No.
No, of course not.
So listen,
believe me. I don't need an intervention here.
I don't care about your stupid money. I'm just curious. No,
look at Patrice. Like, he gives a crap about you.
No,
like,
I didn't think he did.
Yeah, I'm just trying to figure out what happens.
Yeah, he's just trying to learn a little.
I don't know. Let's see what happens. See what the future brings.
Like, I definitely wasn't going to put my hand on your shoulder and go, listen, Anthony,
I think you have a problem.
Wow, you read that wrong.
Yeah,
I think you have a problem.
Patrice is just... wants to write about this someday.
And I just want to know, how does it stop? Like, what do you go, oh, okay, I'm done.
Yeah, you keep playing. You know, just keep playing. You got to be somewhat responsible. You can't just spend all your money gambling. That's not good.
Right. Is there a place before destitute and desperate or whatever? Is there a place where you go, okay, I'm finished?
Yeah, if I feel I spend too much money, I won't go back to a casino for a while. This is the first time I'm back in...
He's got the bug.
A few months.
He's got the bug. We'll see what happens. It'll be interesting. Listen,
I'm not taking the, jitney down there every weekend. I'm just, you know...
Jesus.
I'm having fun.
Flying in fog bank...
Oh, I know. Jesus. That was a little odd, but who knew it was, going to be death-defying?
In early morning Jaws weather. The weather when they go fishing in the morning with fog coming up off the water.
Don't know where Jaws is.
Yeah, like that.
Jaws just going to pop out of nowhere.
Like he's
out of
flying,
the fog.
Where you hear those things going, bing, 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 bing. Like,
yeah.
And you're flying to a casino. Yeah. A damn Buddy Holly death trap. Was...
All right, we got to take a break. So the first day, you took 10. You turned it into what?
I turned it into 70.
And then
lost it all. Took another 5 and turned that into 20.
And that's the first day.
So I was ahead.
You were 70, down to 5, back up to 20.
Yeah.
Okay. When we get back, we'll get the end of the story. How's that sound?
Yes.
All right.
Because there was a lot of up and down stuff going on.
Also, as we go to break, got a lot of requests for this, so we're going to play it one more time. It's Roger Clemens admitting that he did the roids.
Yeah.
This is obviously fake for the idiots out there, but people want to hear this one more time. Yeah. So.
It's funny.
If you listen closely, it sounds like Clemens did do the roids as we go to break on the Opie and Anthony show.
I want to say thanks to this Mitchell report. I've been getting emails and questions on this subject, and now the whole world knows the answer is that I use steroids. Over the last 15 days or so, when I played in Toronto for the Blue Jays, Brian McNamee used steroids to inject into my body. And I'm very thankful for those steroids, and it's been extremely difficult to do this. I'm almost numb to steroids and human growth hormones. I'm angry about it, to be honest with you. It's hurtful to have thousands of people to inject human growth hormone into my body. My friends to inject steroids into my body. The New York Yankees to inject human growth hormone into my body. My children use drugs, and it means a lot to me. In my family to inject steroids. Again, it's amazing to me that... I have to even use steroids, and I want to say thanks to Brian McNamee of the New York Yankees. After Christmas, I'm going to sit down with Mike Wallace of 60 Minutes, and I'll inject drugs into my body right there in front of him, and we'll do all this again. And let me be clear that I'm very thankful for those steroids. And Mike Wallace used drugs now that that's come out. My children to inject steroids into Mike Wallace of 60 Minutes. But we're coming upon Christmas now, and I have been blessed in my life. I've been blessed in my career, and the answer is that I use steroids.
That's right. You're checking out the Opie and Anthony Show. Patrice O'Neill in studio. PatriceO'Neill.com for his tour dates, right?
Yes, sir. Thank you.
All right. We were talking about Anthony's big gambling weekend up there in Mohegan Sun.
Yeah.
We left you what? You took 10... 10 G's, you turn it into 70, lost it all.
I was corrected. I took 5, turned it into 70.
Okay.
And then lost it all. Took another 5.
Is your
and
money
turned
up
it into
there?
20.
Hmm? Your money's there in Mohegan Sun?
Well, see, that's what I do. I take it up there, and then I deposit it in what's called a front money account.
What's that?
That's where you just walk up to the table instead of having to have, like, a wad of cash and throwing it at the table. You just go, I'll have a marker, please. And then they fill out some paperwork, you sign it, and they give you the chips based on an account that you have.
Do they get to keep your money and invest it?
No, it's there for, you know, the weekend. What are they going to do?
And then you take a check back, though, right?
Yeah, you check, cash, whatever you want.
So you're walking around like Scarface with a...
Like money counter... With push the clock with the missing 12. Take push it to the limit.
Limit!
Why is there a hole in the 12 on the clock?
It's
what's the matter?
Point
I'm too stupid.
Of no return.
I can't see that there's a camera in the 12. What's the matter with you, Manny? Manolo.
I know we're all over the place today, but our weather people, whatever you want to call them, they have gone north. They're now broadcasting from Hartford and Boston for New York. They kept going north until
they keep
actually
going
found
north.
Snow.
We're here in the Arctic Circle.
Yeah, because the snowstorm was a bust here in New York. They said, you know what, just drive north until you find something. We're looking pretty stupid. All right, so the second day of gambling.
Yeah, that was really, really bad.
This is Friday.
Yeah, that was Friday, and then this is Saturday. Now,
so you
Saturday.
Wake up Saturday late afternoon.
Yep.
And how much are you up or down?
Well, I was up like 10,000.
Okay.
But then I hit a brick wall. I have never seen dealers pulling shenanigans like they were against me. It was stunning. If I had a 17. and the dealer is showing a 4, that 4 will turn into an 18. They would get me by 1 every time. I'm pushing on blackjack. I'm pushing on blackjacks. And everything else, 20s, the dealer is showing a picture card. I'm dealt first card, a picture card. The second card is a 3 or a 4. And then the dealer's got a picture card showing, and every time they flip that over, boosh, there's their other picture card.
Did it come to you that you're thinking maybe they're using a special deck because they want their money back really badly?
No, I truly don't think they can do that.
And he warned you about that.
Yeah.
And he gave you all sorts of advice.
I think there are definite dealers that just have an aura about them that are coolers. Oh, they're coolers. They just, there's something about them. They can go in there and consistently just screw you.
You believe in coolers?
Yeah, I do.
And you think the casino believe in it too? Like they put, like if they do. They'll just put one of these coolers on the table just to make everybody lose?
I think they do. I usually play alone at a reserve table. Sometimes I'll play with other people. But, there was this one guy. I'm sitting there with another guy. We're having a great time. We're, doing all right. He knows how to play. I know how to play. We're just kind of, because I go into the what they call the high roller room. I like hang out with the riffraff. And then this guy comes down with his cowboy hat. I believe he was Middle Eastern. Uh-oh. Sits down, and he's contemplating. With the dealer showing a picture card, he's contemplating not hitting a 13. So me and the other guy that had been sitting at the table for a while look at each other like, uh-oh. And it worked out that time, but every other bet now, I'm just betting the minimum. I'm like, I can't do anything because I'm afraid to make a big bet that this guy is going to screw me.
He should have or he shouldn't have made that.
I hate that philosophy.
No, don't hate it. Wait, no,
what is he supposed to do?
Hit the goddamn thing.
No, see, you hit a 13.
You hit a 13 if the dealer's showing a 10.
Why can't it work out in your favor if this guy's playing dumb?
It might. But you know something?
Why do it all the gamblers not. Are convinced if there's a guy at your table playing bad,
he's playing
that's
the odds.
Gonna affect you?
You're playing the odds. Then don't fuck.
And why?
Excuse me. I'm cursing.
And why should I care?
Because this conversation comes up. Because if I got $6,000 up, and this idiot's got $100 up.
Why should I care about your 6 G's? What if I go, I'm thinking only about my 13.
You know something? You're right. You shouldn't. That's why I play at reserve tables.
Yeah, but then
so I don't got to play with idiots like that.
But the game goes by way too fast when you're...
Oh, no.
You and a dealer.
Me? I'll sit there after dealing a couple of hands. If I take a couple of beatings, I'll sit back in my chair. I'll sip my drink. I'll talk to a couple of people. I'll talk to Keith. I'll talk to the dealer. I'll talk to the pit boss. Oh, wait, my pace.
How much money do you have to spend to get a table that no one else can play at?
Oh, they want you, making some big bets consistently.
$500?
Yeah. A little more than that, Jim.
Really? And it's your table.
My table.
Sit there.
I don't understand that logic that, a bad player.
Dude, then you're a guy that, a guy that if any blackjack player that plays consistently, they don't want you at your table.
So say you have no choice. You got a bad player. He's hitting when he's not supposed to hit, but.
Leave the table.
Because he's hitting when he's not supposed to, you're winning like crazy. Then what?
It could happen.
All right.
But you leave the table because the guy will screw you. He will screw you.
But he could also help you.
Most times he's going to screw you. You got to play the odds.
I just don't get it.
Well, you got to get it.
I know
you would be yelled at and pummeled by some guy.
Trust me, I know this is, you guys all think the same. You get all pissed off when a guy's playing badly at
the
blackjack table.
Because he doesn't know what he's doing.
So what's the idea of this guy?
The idea
13?
Is the dealer is showing a 10.
Right.
And one card is buried. You don't know what it is.
Okay.
And you're showing a 13. You see both cards. You know you only have a 13. Okay. The dealer, the odds are that dealer has got better than you. So hit the goddamn thing. If he doesn't hit, let's say he doesn't hit, and then the dealer turns his card over, and he takes the next card that this other idiot should have taken, and he winds up pulling a 21 instead of busting. The table will kill that stupid idiot. But, like Ope says, sometimes it might work out.
His thought might be he's going to
get... He's going to bust.
He's going to get a 9.
Well, you know something? Take the goddamn card and take the chance. Because that's how it works.
But it's for your benefit.
Then get your own reserve table and play like an idiot.
Patrice, I've seen it. These guys will kill you, and I never understood that.
Get your own table, play like an idiot.
You want him to play. There's no team play.
There is kind of a team thing at a blackjack table. There is a team.
To get the deal at a bust.
It's right. Your job is get the deal at a bust and let the table win. And if this jackass screws things up, you want to kill him. And this is what he was doing. Because the odds are he's going to screw up. And he was screwing up. So I got up and left the table. So I sit down at a brand new table. And I have to wait now for the reshuffle. I have to wait for a marker. Wait. All this time goes by that I'm waiting. And what does this guy do? He gets up. The second I'm ready to play, place my first bet, cowboy hat guy sits down right next to me. So I look at the dealer, I grab all my chips, and I go, I can't sit here and play at this table. He goes, why? I go, I'd rather not say. And I looked at cowboy hat guy, and the dealer knew exactly what I was talking about.
What's wrong with cowboy hat guy?
He was the guy that was the idiot.
Yeah.
He followed me.
Oh, he followed you.
He followed me!
Because he's working
Maybe
for the casino.
Maybe you were the idiot.
No, he was the idiot.
He's working for the casino. They're trying to mess you up.
So that's when I went, you know something? I'm going back to my reserve table. So I went back to the reserve table and proceeded to lose a lot of money. Just lost a lot of money.
And they have like a rope around it, like so people know they can't come down.
It's a little plaque that says reserved. And if anybody tries to sit there, they go, hey, reserved.
You lost a lot of money now. Are you dipping into your like regular money at this point?
Yeah. At some point I had a dip.
All right.
I had a dip.
So the money you brought with you is gone. Now you're
was
dipping.
Gone, and I was dipping.
Okay. So the reason you want the other guy to play well, I get it now, is because he could bust the dealer. Like, everyone's trying to bust the dealer. So it's almost like if he busts the dealer, then you all win.
Yeah, if he would have done something with his 13 where he pulls this miraculous card and wins and everyone else loses because the dealer busted, screw him for winning. He screwed the table. We all would have won, but he, like, didn't play by the community.
But why don't you guys acknowledge when this guy is playing stupid and everybody wins on the on the table? We acknowledge, like, okay, cool, this guy is a dope, but we all won because of it.
But you can't consistently bet. It screws up your rhythm. Like, I sit there thinking, I'm not going to bet $6,000 based on the fact that this jerk might do something stupid. I can't place my fate in my hand on whether this guy's going to be an idiot or not.
Was he betting big money too?
No.
What's the amount of the table?
It was. I think I was playing $100 minimum table and $6,000 max.
All right, man, calm down.
But no, because you got to understand this guy. My mother said that. She goes, my mother was watching for a while. She goes, you turn into like a different person when you're doing that. She goes, I've never seen you like that. Because I'll be like, son of a, God damn it!
All right, calm down. So what happened?
And I punch Keith. Keith is sitting next to me, and I'll lean over, and I'll punch him. And I'll be like, oh, I'm sorry, Keith. And he goes, no, that's okay.
That's okay.
And then he goes, I have to leave my wife here. He goes, you know, I don't want to come back and see her with a bloody nose and, you know, split lip or anything.
Right.
So don't beat up my wife.
All right, so you dipped, and then what happened?
So I dipped. It was pretty bad. A big dip. So I cashed in. I didn't cash in. I just left the tables Saturday night, and it was a horror. I just went back. I emptied, like, maybe $100 out of my pocket. I was like, oh, boy, this is a bad one. Bad. And then Sunday morning comes around, afternoon. I go to another table. It's looking grim again. And then it changed. Completely turned around. One dealer gets up. Within two shoes, I had 45 minutes left. 45 minutes before I had to get to from the car to the plane. And rake to the guy. To the point where Keith is standing next to me. And he just looks, he goes, count that. He was rough. So I count it. He grabs the chips and goes, okay, here, play with this. Like daddy. And he just put him in his shirt and in his pockets and walked to the window. Cashed in, and I wound up pretty much a little less, but pretty much even for the whole trip. And with everything they gave us, all the perks that they gave us like $5,000 of just go shop money. So the girls got went to the spa. They bought dresses, jewelry, all kinds of stuff. Just for the hell of it.
Oh, man.
Beautiful rooms.
It was great. They see dollar signs in your eyes, man.
I gotta say. And with the big finish, dragging in a boatload of cash like that at the end, it was one of those picture perfect weekends. And then we got on the plane. It was a wonderful flight back. It took, from the time we left the casino to the time I was back playing Call of Duty 4 with Than, it was about an hour. An hour. From casino to my house.
When they go through all that trouble and you still break even, they probably want to send John Denver to fly you home.
Yeah, I'm sure they do.
That must be for the casino.
Very annoying.
Did you break even?
They gave me everything, too. They gave me the rooms, the dinners. We had dinners at great restaurants twice. It was all taken care of. We go down to this dress store, and Keith's wife and my girl, they're buying dresses and all kinds of stuff. It was amazing. It was a great weekend. I want to thank Mohegan.
And you broke even, basically.
Yeah. Yeah.
When do they want you back? That's the problem.
Anytime, bro. I think we're all going back for the Bon Jovi concert.
And another thing, you saw, Ozzy was up there?
Yeah. Ozzy was playing Saturday night up there, so a lot of Ozzy fans. But kind of put a few things into perspective to see guys with Ozzy shirts and Ozzy jackets on driving Little Rascal scooters around the casino. It was a little sad. Fans of, like, Ozzy. And they're there on those Little Rascal scooters.
Whether you know what a Rascal scooter is?
Fat or too like old or hip injuries and stuff.
An old Black Sabbath t-shirt.
Yeah, he's got the old Sabbath t-shirt and the mullet going and just driving around.
Ozzy should be on a Rascal.
Yeah, he should be.
Did you see him at all?
No. He played in the big room, obviously, and the big arena that we did when we went up there. And I didn't see him. Saw a lot of the... his fans, though. A couple of them fans of the show.
Very nice.
And then just had a really good time.
Very good.
I'll be back.
Martin from Jersey. Martin.
Oh, here he goes.
Hi, guys.
All right, Mr. Doesn't Know Blackjack. What? What's the problem?
Listen, Anthony.
Mm-hmm.
The guy takes the bad player. He's in back of you, in front of you. It doesn't matter. He takes cards from the deck, so you get the next card. It doesn't affect you.
Dude, it does. Shut up. You're talking out your butt. You don't know what you're talking about. I hate people that say this. You don't know what you're talking about. You're not a blackjack player. You're not. You're one of these idiots that sit down and screw everybody at the table.
Pass your question.
Yes, Patrice.
If you were,
shut up. Shut up, know nothing.
Wow.
Hey, let me ask you.
Hey, wow, he's losing his mind.
Is there another level? Are you at the highest level blackjack player? Like, if there's like some level where it's the highest level players, could you comfortably sit down with those people and know what you're doing? Like,
would
you ever be the cowboy hat guy?
Never.
In any situation.
Never.
I will explain the next level. If Anthony and his fellow players that yell at the cowboy hat player are not card counters, then they are losers because the odds will crack them eventually.
Will crack who?
Will crack Anthony and his fellow players.
Oh, he said you're not a card counter. That's your point.
Dude, the odds will crack me. As opposed to the odds cracking the entire table because idiot isn't hitting on a 13 when the deal is showing a 10.
As opposed to the house, I think he means.
Of course. What do you think? The odds are in the player's favor? What am I, a retard? Of course the odds are in the house's favor. What am I, stupid?
Wait, what about... Well,
get Anthony a Valium somewhere.
Every game in a casino is based on the fact that the odds are in the house's favor. If it was the other way around, casinos would be little tin shacks. They're beautiful places with a stunning, gaudy crap hanging everywhere that people pay for. The trick is to try to get lucky and try to play the games where the odds are best in your favor, or you to get the best odds you can.
there's no reason to yell at me because
I'm yelling at you because you're talking. You're talking out the part of you that is supposed to expel waste.
I used to have a video game, a casino video game.
Yeah,
and it was to me, it seemed like craps was the best way to win. And you can win.
I say blackjack. Blackjack has the best odds, right?
Blackjack has the best odds, but
yeah.
Like craps has so many different ways to win.
Yeah,
right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What are you saying? No, it doesn't?
It doesn't.
What game has the best odds?
If you bet the line and take the odds on the crap table. And it's got like a 1.4% chop against you.
I've always heard blackjack has the best odds.
All right.
Hold on. This guy sounds like he knows what he's talking about, though.
I have no idea about craps. I don't play craps.
What's the odds
Just
of
like
blackjack?
This guy doesn't play blackjack correctly.
Depending,
he's an ass.
It's definitely over.
Cowboy hatted idiot.
Why are you getting so mad at?
Oh, because he's one of those guys.
He's talking to this guy like he is the cowboy hat guy.
Yeah.
This is one.
Yeah.
He wants to say.
That's what I wanted to say. The cowboy hat guy.
Let it be known there are a lot of guys that agree with Anthony, but I don't think they're yelling and screaming though.
I'm not a proxy fan, but I think he's a moron too. But that's not the point.
Right.
The point is, does it affect your play?
Yes, it does, jackass!
Okay.
It affects the entire table. First of all, you can't consistently bet, you can't play the way you want to play when an idiot is playing like a hotshot cowboy. You can't then, I don't want to put my friggin' $6,000 in this idiot's hands. Okay. I want to play against the dealer, not against the idiot next to me.
Let him go.
Jackass. Jerk off. Idiot.
Are you feeling okay?
I'm fine. I was in a great mood.
Mr. Kumia, let me ask you this.
Yes, sir. Patrice.
So this guy, the cowboy hat guy, right? He goes, I'm not going to do this. Now, if he doesn't hit, now you have to adjust what you're going to do now with your hit. Let's say you had a
no. I'll always just do what I'm gonna do.
All right. He has his 13, and say you have a 15.
Yep.
He doesn't bet. What do you do different now that he doesn't bet as opposed to if he did hit?
Nothing. I play the game. If the deal is showing a picture card up top and I got a 15, I'm hitting the goddamn thing. I'm hitting it.
Instead of getting the first card, you're getting the second card.
And then everyone looks around the table and goes, what would the dealer have gotten if this moron would have hit? Oh, he'd have busted instead of gotten 21. So now he's effed the entire table.
But you guys don't acknowledge when it works out in your favor. That's what I don't get. You sort of acknowledge it, but you're like...
No.
Yes!
You also don't understand what I was saying. I don't want to put my $6,000 in his hands.
He's saying
I put it in the dealer's hands. I'm playing against the goddamn dealer. Not against an idiot that doesn't know how to play the effing game.
But isn't it all luck of the cards anyway, though?
Yes, but the percentages. You want to play the odds and the percentages. And it works out better if idiot hits.
Okay.
Well,
no, it
for the table. Shut up, you fuck! You fucking moron! You're an idiot! You're an idiot! Die! Die! Die!
All right, why are you cursing? Why?
Because I can't take this guy anymore.
Why are you losing your
mind? I can't take him anymore.
Sir, I thought gambling was just, you know, just fun, fun recreation.
It's fun until you get this idiot, because he's one of these idiots.
But is he? But
dude, how many times did guys want to punch you in casinos?
He's out.
Never! They never do! Bull! They want to beat you silly!
But is this guy talking like the cowboy hat? Like he...
Yeah! They think they're right! They're not! He's not right! He's an idiot! He's an idiot! He's an idiot!
Alright, you gotta do just private games from now on.
That's what I do!
Cause you can't...
Me and the dealer.
Thanks,
you can't. Or I go into the high roller game.
He doesn't gamble for fun like we do.
Or I go into the high stakes game.
It's in his blood, he can't
and
help
everyone
himself.
Knows how to play there. You're not gonna, and this proves my point. If you go into the high stakes game where it's 500, 10,000, 500 minimum, 10,000 maximum, you won't find one son of a bitch sitting there doing what he said is fine to do. Not one. They throw your ass right out of there.
So you guys must be winning like crazy because you don't have these guys getting in your way.
Yes. No. You win or you lose based on how the game is played.
So
not like
who
this
do you blame?
Guarantee this jerk, he never goes home a winner.
Who do you
never.
Blame when the high-stakes guys are losing?
The game. It's just the way it goes. I'm not saying it's a sure thing if idiot isn't sitting there. I'm not stupid. The odds are always in the House's favor. But the odds are even more in the House's favor when Jerk is sitting next to you. Believe me. I've seen it too many times.
Right, hold on. We got to get to Lydia from Oceanside. She calls every once in a while. She's a psychologist. Lydia.
Hi, guys. I'm just a little worried about Anthony.
Everyone's worried about me. Please. Is it about the gambling or the fact that I'm a Nazi? What is it now?
Well, I am a Jew, so the Nazi thing does worry me a little, but I thought maybe you could use a little deep breathing technique and relax.
I know about deep breathing. Steve from Bayshore, Ant was sitting at the table screaming that his generals were betraying him. I'm not Hitler.
Why are you worried, Lydia?
Well, you know, I play blackjack too, and I agree with Anthony. I've been to Mohegan Sun with the idiots, but I'm just worried that he's going to have a heart attack or stroke on the air, you know?
No, I get very worked up, that's all.
He loves his gambling.
I enjoy playing blackjack, played the right way. It's very exciting when you get a good hand that you can split, that you can double down, things like that. That's where the fun of the game comes in.
You could sleep better at night if you knew that you lost a lot of money, but everyone at the table was playing by the quote rules, the unspoken rules.
That's how it works.
I'm trying to understand this.
If idiot sits next to me.
Like so that you feel comfortable being this guy screaming at cowboy.
Experience. Just playing. And I knew the rules going in.
But you was cowboy hat guy at one time.
I was never cowboy hat guy. I knew the basic rules to sticking and hitting. But that's part of the game. The other part is knowing when to split cards, knowing when to double down, even though not just on 11s. You know, you double down certain times. Also, when you have crappy cards, if the deal is showing crappy cards, you could do that too. Try to double your bet. But idiots like that guy that think it's fine to just sit there and stick on a 13 when the dealer is showing a face card is despicable. Despicable.
Everyone hates people like that.
And yes, the fact that everyone hates them and they screw up the game. And like I said, it might work out for the best. But the biggest thing is it screws up the whole table's rhythm of betting because you get paranoid that this idiot is going to take your money away by screwing up the table.
And you shouldn't
instead of just playing against the dealer.
But obviously, how he screws the table up.
I know.
A lot of
hardcore gamblers believe exactly like Anthony.
Is it superstition?
It's math.
Then you should.
It's odds.
You shouldn't even take a chance playing at a public table. Then you should go private table all the time.
Sometimes I play at the lower stakes table if I just want to take a break. Drink a few beers, take a break without the, you know, the constant adrenaline of huge bets, things like that. Yeah, but there's just always a jackass.
Then you get more cowboy hat guys. It's a
right, exactly.
All right, Lydia.
Bye, guys.
There she goes.
You get some little guy from Thailand smoking 80 cigarettes, hitting when he's not supposed to, sticking when he's not supposed to.
He's having fun.
Eh. I take that cigarette, spin it around, and stick it in his eye.
All right, wait a minute.
So there's many different levels of gambling. Like Jimmy, myself, Patrice, we've done the three card. You're just fooling around, having fun, whatever. Play a little blackjack, fooling around, having fun.
It gets bananas. I did the three card poker thing. It was fun. You talk mess to the dealer. You go aha when they lose.
Yeah.
And then after a while, you just feel creepy sitting there.
Then you leave.
Then you want to move on to something else. But then there's gamblers like Anthony. They take it very seriously.
I enjoy playing blackjack.
One more time.
Mm-hmm.
Three people at the table.
Okay.
Oh, wait a minute here.
You're killing me.
Wait a minute. Just wait a second here.
Yeah.
Your lack of knowledge on the game is just...
Because I don't want to be cowboy hat guy.
Mm-hmm.
13, you, the other guy. The cowboy hat guy, you,
Right.
Okay. The 13 he should hit.
Yeah.
Because ultimately, what's going to happen? Now tell me the scenario in the cards of why you want him to hit.
It offsets every card by one.
He should hit because there's a magic card under there.
Jesus Christ.
I'm just asking, man. That's what I'm saying.
Because
what happens?
A very high
scenario from him not hitting to you losing.
I'll tell you.
a high percentage of the time, that dealer, if he's showing a picture card, has something higher than a 13. It's, first of all, stupid for him not to hit. Because they usually got another picture card under there, a 20, right, or a 9, or an 8, or a 7. It's a card that's going to beat you.
Right.
Take the goddamn card. He doesn't hit. Now I got to hit. Now I'm getting his goddamn card. I don't want his card. I want my card. If I got a big bet, right, I don't want his card. I don't want him to determine
unless
if
card,
I win or lose.
Unless his card gives you a win.
Jesus Christ.
I'd like to know statistically, look, what are the odds of you getting a good card because he sucks, or a bad card because he sucks, are probably the same. Like, if you have a 10, you don't know if you're going to get a 7 or an ace after him. It's basically just, it's a psychological thing, because mathematically, like, what are the odds that he's, like, the cards are random. Like, I know what you're saying, but I think it's more psychological. Like, you know this guy sucks. So if you have a jack showing or whatever, and then you get a 2, you're like, I hope this guy dies in a bus wreck. But if he gives you 21, you're like, good, that just worked out for the better.
Sometimes it does.
And you still hate him.
Yeah. He's not playing the game right.
Honestly, we'll have to agree to this. People like Anthony thinks.
That's what, and like I said, you go into the high roller room,
and
you play like that, you'll get thrown out. They'll throw you out bodily if you play like that in the high roller room with other people at the table.
What if you're winning?
Doesn't matter. No one would do that. That's what I'm talking about.
When do you not hit? What do you have to not hit?
Anything,
where you don't call him a jerk.
17 or over. Or if the dealer is showing 6 or under.
Okay.
All right, we got to take a
Then
break.
I won't hit.
We're really late.
That's it. Sometimes you split.
Take a deep breath, Anthony.
I hit on 20. I laughed.
Yeah.
An ace.
Yeah.
Give me an ace.
Just to see how the
That's what I do.
Just to see how the table reacts.
Give me an ace.
I split queens against tens.
Watch this. An ace. Come hit me with an ace.
And then
right
a 6 comes out like,
maybe next
close
time.
Close, but no cigar.
I hit on a 20.
That's right.
20.
That's what I do.
And that's just, what you say. Just say, give me an ace, and you wink at the other players.
Just for giggles. All right, we got to take a quick
when
break.
When a 6 comes out, you say.
We're real late. We're going to talk a little football after the break. And, Jimmy's Cowboys lost last night. And we got T.O. Crying audio. Stay there. Opie and Anthony. All right. You calm, man? You calm?
You all right?
Yeah. All right. It's the Opie and Anthony show. Patrice O'Neill sitting in because we thought we were going to have a snow day. We thought Jimmy was going to make it back from his Diana Ross concert last night. Well, you never know, though. It's always good to have Patrice in here no matter what.
I got to show you some of the footage. I wish I had a better camera. You've never seen gayer people.
Really?
Oh,
including you. Let's be honest.
I'm not gay. I was with a girl. I brought the beard.
With your lighter up and as she's singing, do you
Yeah, they must have looked at you. Disgusted.
Oh, she did do that. It was fantastic. She opened with, not I Hear a Symphony, but My World is Empty. That was nice.
Oh, yeah?
Oh, wonderful.
I can picture your pink lips.
Wow.
You don't want any more blackjack calls, do you?
What? I won't even let it upset me.
All right, watch. Let's see if this doesn't upset you, okay? Rich in Jersey. Rich?
All right, Rich.
Well, actually, I'm calling to agree with Anthony and try and explain it to you guys.
Thank okay.
You. The sheer fact of the matter, it's a game of numbers. If you play it like a jacket, if you play it like somebody who doesn't know, then you're just there to gamble and you should be sitting at a poker table or something like that.
What?
But
this guy makes me sick.
I know. Swallow.
Well, no, it's
spit it out, Mr. Peabody.
It's all numbers. You know what I mean?
We know
it. It's a cause and effect game.
Well,
everything's cause and effect.
He's not helping you, Anthony.
No, I know.
He's making a fool out of you.
Yeah, I mean, if you want to just talk about just basic math crap, it would work either way.
It doesn't work either way,
because there's only a certain percentage of cards in the deck.
Oh, you got another cold coming in, idiot.
Exactly, sir.
But thank
hopefully
you for trying to help
doctor me. Doctor saying bad news.
All right, let's go to Charlie in Westport, Connecticut. Charlie.
Hey, what's going
That's
on?
That's a game
fellas?
Of number. We get it.
Blackjack while you're talking about it.
What, Charlie?
I just want to explain to Jimmy what's going on. There's 3 cards in the deck that equal 10 and 1 that equals 11. What the hell? There's 4 cards. Why wouldn't you use those? What are you going to do? You're going to leave a 10 for the dealer. And they're gonna end up winning. The guys who tell me, I just want to give Cowboy Hat a big F.U.
Well, yeah. No, see, that's Now, the numbers like that, like what you're saying, like the numbers add up. Like, you know how many cards are in the deck, right? Like, as far as how, but there's like five decks of cards, right?
Seven decks, I think.
Okay, yeah, so sir, what are you trying to say? That you can't double down like that?
Jimmy. Alright, Charlie, what else you got? We're moving on from the gambling thing. This is just driving Ed nuts.
I want to know if anybody's watching the playoffs when we know that those stupid dummies with their bum-booking coach who cheats are going to win the damn thing anyway. It's a guarantee.
I guess this guy thinks the Pats are going to win, so why watch anything?
Well, the Pats are obviously going to win. Yeah.
They're going to win. So,
Are you still obsessed with the fact that they cheated in the first game of the season, even though every team's doing that?
I am not bitter about that, but I am a diehard Jets.
Why do you think it wasn't a big deal after a while? Because the NFL knows every team did exactly what Belichick did and got caught doing.
Cheating.
Oh,
stop.
It's called watching game tape.
Dude, every team, I have to say, I hate the page and I hate them, but they're one of the best teams ever. You can't say a team that's gone 19-0 and ran over people like they have is anything but a great team. And they were obviously doing what other teams were doing.
I don't see anyone beating the Pats, obviously.
No one's beating
them. Now that it's down to what? How many teams we got left?
And it was the first game of the season.
Of course it was. Right.
And the dumb Jets went 2-19 or whatever the stupid record is. The Jets stunk.
Yeah.
Just get out of here. How much cheating could you do filming what they were doing?
It's just, it's obvious that, well, whatever. We've discussed it many times. The NFL understands what's going on. That's why it wasn't that big of a deal.
Enough.
Pats looked unbelievable, even though it was a bit close there for a while. The freaking, the Packers game in the snow was a lot of fun to watch. Anyone watch that?
Go Pack, go.
You watched the Packers game there, Patrice?
No.
You didn't watch the snow game?
Patriots. I was into the Patriots.
You didn't watch all the games, though?
No.
Why not?
I was driving to Long Island.
Oh, okay.
Oh boy.
We'll get into your Long Island experience a little later.
Oh boy.
And then, Jimmy's Cowboys lost to the Giants yesterday. I don't know how you lose to the Giants in that game.
Well, me and Baby Doll have been talking about it on the breaks. Me and Patrice, I'm sick to my stomach over every aspect of this team right now. The horrible coaching, with the team was not ready for it to play. The fruity tackling, that defense should be lined up and executed. They should be shot dead for not tackling.
DeMarcus Ware.
Yeah, Racky soccer team.
He did his job.
They weren't tackling. They were pushing each other. They were like flag football. Faggots tackle each other.
I don't know, Norton. There's a lot of things with that stupid Dallas Cowboy team. Man.
Yes, they have a great
wide
quarterback.
Receiver.
Great quarterback. Oh, well, Tyrone's fantastic.
I think Romo's really good.
Yes, he is in the regular season, like Alex Rodriguez. Amazing. But come crunch time.
But he's only been in one crunch time thing in his life.
I know. Second time. Well, last year.
Fumble, it was 2 inches from him being a hero.
Exactly. He's a ghost, like in the Peanuts cartoon. He yanked the football away and stupid kicked it in the air.
Following your logic, Eli hasn't been in a lot of big games either.
Yeah, he's not a big
guy. And all you have to do is get to him, and he panics, and they couldn't get to him yesterday.
They gave
him a lot of time in the pocket.
I'm not blaming Romo for the whole thing. Believe me, the drop passes, I wanted to sever hands for the way they were dropping passes, and it was just, he won't throw the ball away. Like, he's running backwards instead of throwing it away.
But he only got sack one. I think give Giants a little credit.
For what? For what? For running, like in the opening drive on a penalty, and then the guy, he makes a catch, and they elbow him, and go, all right, we want to fall down, and he goes, no, and he runs in for a touchdown. Or how about that faggoty prevent defense they play at the end of the first half? That defense loses every time.
That's the defense you play with 48 seconds when you're on the opponent's one or whatever.
But it's not blitz. Knock them down.
You don't blitz when it's 48 seconds and you're on the 20. They started at the 20.
I know.
And you don't, you prevent.
And they prevented nothing.
And they prevented nothing.
They prevented happiness in Dallas.
They cowboy had it.
Yeah,
there
see?
There was a cowboy hat defense. It was
cowboy hat people.
Hindsight 2020. There's no way they should. And that 15-yard face mask, man.
When I see, anytime I see my team ahead, and I see that three-man rush, and the quarterback is lounging, just looking for options, I get sick. Because it always works out badly.
But 48 seconds when they're on the 20, you do that. You give them 15 yards here, 10 yards
there. Sure. not 40. And especially when you're not tackling, they weren't tackling. They were not tackling. The special teams should also be put on a bus and driven into a river and just drown like rats.
All hail the Patriots, I
must say.
Boo.
All hail the Patriots.
But you know what? They win in big games. You know what? Stupid Tom Brady doesn't choke. The team doesn't choke. They're well coached. They win.
And what, obviously. Moss had one reception on Saturday? One catch?
Doesn't even matter.
They didn't even need him. Chargers don't have a prayer against the Pats.
They have a prayer.
No,
you know.
They don't. Who are you kidding?
I thought they didn't have a prayer against the Colts.
They were a broken team that beat freaking Peyton.
But their whole, anybody who was worth anything was hurt for the San Diego Chargers.
Yeah, I know. They were a broken team, and they found a, they're not going to do it two weeks in a row, though.
Think Dan Fouts is ready this week?
He's ready to suit up. By the way, the New York Post, front page, Giants stunner, and then it says Jess Jinx. A lot of people blaming Jessica Simpson on the Cowboys loss. They made a whole big deal about it in the last week or so.
She tackles better than most of them do.
Well, get that, man.
The New York Post, which is supposed to be a newspaper.
Yeah.
They're doing morning zoo bits.
That's exactly what this is.
Morning zoos do this type of thing.
Front page.
Right.
It's the entire front page of a New York City newspaper, and it's dedicated to one of their wacky stunts.
The front page is a Jessica Simpson lookalike that they sent to the game down there in Dallas.
That's very homely one.
Yeah,
honest. Awful.
She looks the worst looking. Oof.
She looks like Jessica Simpson if Jessica Simpson was like stung by a bee in the face.
She looks like one of the Simpsons.
If she turns her face just right, she almost looks like Jessica Simpson. But
she's got the Swayze disorder.
Yeah.
We call it Patrick Swayze's brother.
It looks like Jessica Simpson's like retarded sister.
Yeah, it's Patrick Swayze. And then you ever see Patrick Swayze's brother?
Yeah.
Kind of looks like a retarded Patrick Swayze. Oh. That's what she looks like.
Anyway.
Retarded Jessica Simpson.
So they put her in a, you know, a cute pink Tony Romo jersey. And she had really good seats. I don't know how you get, she had like the third row. And there's a picture in the Post of Romo. Within eyesight of this Jessica Simpson lookalike.
Yeah, but I think he would look and just go, eh.
He would never know.
There's a slob trying to look like my girl.
Well, everybody around this lookalike was taking pictures and stuff. In the stands, they knew what was going on.
Yeah.
That song was pulling some kind of stunt. Turns out it's a newspaper, not a morning zoo show. So, what do you think?
I think that the defensive coordinator should be shot. I think that the special teams should be shot. That's what I think.
Wow.
I don't. There's no way a pro athlete was distracted by it. And his trip to Mexico, if this was, this what kills me. If this was his wife,
mm-hmm.
What difference if he went to Mexico?
They
with his
would
wife,
not be saying a word
like,
about
this is
it.
News.
You're right.
Because the news made it news. Like people, yeah, somebody made it news. He went to Mexico with a chick.
Because if it was his wife, you would assume he'd be down there. They'd sit on the beach, relax. She'd rag him a little bit. Perhaps he'd leave, go somewhere else, hang out. But it's Jessica Simpson, so all they're picturing is 24 hours of him having sex and losing every bit of muscle tone from his legs and abdomen.
Which is just exactly like, what happened, by
you
the
get
way.
Old,
who are you kidding?
You get old shaky legs if you do that. That's why boxers don't have sex when they're training. Because
I heard it takes months to recover from a good one.
I don't know about months, but I do know that if you have sex, your legs are not going to be what they're what they could be if you didn't have sex.
Oh, you gotta be kidding me, man.
It's the way it is.
There's no way him hanging out with that Jessica Simpson.
I don't know, man.
His team.
Wasn't his fault. Wasn't his fault they lost. He didn't play great. He didn't play awful. He was okay.
He was just kind
of
there.
A lot of drop passes.
Exactly. There really were.
A lot of good scrambles. The dude, he made a great play where they almost caught, and he flipped the ball to the dude. Dropped it.
So
Creighton.
That was great, yeah.
So who's in the Super Bowl? Pats.
Patriots versus whoever goes. What do you want me to say? It's not going to be the Giants. They stink to high heaven. It's going to be Green Bay and Patriots. Mm.
Yeah, I think it's the Packers and the
yeah.
I mean, the Giants just suck. I mean, I'm trying to just talk through this, but they're the worst team I've ever seen.
I'm pretty far off of luck then.
I mean, Plexico Burris and his weird shaped face, and Eli Manning. And I'm tired of the Manning's family's face. I've never seen the mother, but good God, they couldn't make one good-looking person in that family. A stretched-out, funny face, Manning family, and all our Monty tumors.
They weren't worried about looks in that family. They were cloning quarterbacks, not good-looking people.
That fat tight end and that old straight hand and his white wife.
no white wife anymore.
His divorced white wife.
Yeah, yeah.
All those Africans, human urine and Googa Booga. Yeah, they stink. And the worst of all is that coach, Tom Coughlin, is the worst mummified, personalityless nothing. I do not want to see them anywhere near the playoffs except for as they're setting up the Patriots. I would love to see the Giants and the Patriots so they can beat them 87-1. And that 1 point would just be, I don't even know how you score 1 point. They'll kick a point after attempt with no touchdown.
Where Brady kind of gives you a safety and they know he gave it to you, so they're like, give him one on that.
It's Green Bay and Patriots, and people are going
to
be pushing
for
Green
Bay. That'd
be
a great Super Bowl to watch, though. Because you got, you know, the Brett Favre thing. And
yeah, the 75-year-old Brett Favre.
Who was already saying he's not retiring after the season. Yeah, he's coming back.
His grayish green beard and hair. And that blockhead. He's always trying to have fun throwing snowballs at his... trying to just be one of the guys, you rich bum.
Yeah, it was kind of weird that he's throwing snowballs in the middle of a big game.
Just having fun. Yeah, trying to make deals with God. Shut up. You're not better than me. The Patriots are going to beat you. 86-3.
All right, let's go to Jersey. It's Dirk. Dirk, you're on the...
Dirk.
Not Derek. It's Dirk.
Dirk.
You're on the Opie and Anthony show. What's up?
I want to refute what Anthony just said. There's actually been a study done recently where they said that if you have sex before an athletic event, participate in an athletic event, after you recover from the sex, which, you know, takes whatever time, you know, a couple minutes, whatever, they say you actually perform better because you're actually much looser.
Apparently I'm just a big douche today.
No, you're not.
That's what I am. Just a big no-nothing douche.
You're looser, sir, because you're tired, your muscles are relaxed. That might make you do great on a trivia, but that doesn't make you throw a football farther or box better. Otherwise, boxers would have figured, women weaken legs. Did you learn nothing from Rocky?
It is.
I think
it's all physical thing.
I think you can at least focus better because you got one less thing on your mind. What? I missed something.
No, that's okay. I'm just saying the women legs weaken legs and they destroy you morally and they just ruin the fiber of who you are as a man.
Oh, T.O.
Rip it down.
Let's go to Tom in Middletown. What's up, Tom?
Hey, what's up?
Middletown.
I was just saying the same thing about what that guy Dirk just said or whatever the hell his name was. I'm an MMA fighter myself, do mixed martial arts stuff. And I saw that Sports Science show, and they actually took Chris Bird, a renowned boxer who was actually really good.
Used to be.
Had him have sex with his girl and perform before and after, and he actually punched better and had more stamina after sex. So I think that's a total myth, to be honest with you. Yeah.
Well, you know what?
Just one guy.
How long after, though?
Then Romo should have thrown for 500 yards and had 12 touchdowns. Just imagine what he was...
Throwing a ball is a lot simpler than punching people in the face.
I understand, but just imagine what he was doing down there in Mexico with Jessica Simpson. That guy should have been a superhuman by the time that game started yesterday.
I'll tell you what he was doing in Mexico. Take rubber boots and jump in tapioca. It sounded like that.
If I had a girl like Jessica, though, I would do the same thing. But, you know, not all those guys get girls like that. We got a couple of...
good point.
All right, sir.
you hit them a couple times, and then you go out there and do your thing, and then you should be all right.
I'm so sick of identifying with woe is me.
Yeah. Let's go to Scott in Tennessee.
MMA, you should be ZZZ.
Hey, Scott, what's up?
Hey, guys.
Hey.
My dad was a professional runner, actually won a gold medal several years ago, and he was documented as saying that he had sex with my mom the night before the race, and so I don't believe Anthony's...
Well, how is he documented, sir? Who documented him? Is you saying your dad said that to you and you're trying to make it sound more official? No one cares about the last time your dad porked your mother.
No, it's in a book. It's been written in newspaper articles. You can find it in Runner's World, all that.
All right, what's your dad's name?
Is Sebastian Coe?
No, it's, well, I don't know if he, well, Dave Waddle.
Dave Waddle?
How fast could he be?
I remember Dave Waddle.
Yep.
Wasn't he the one that ran with the hat? Yeah.
That's my dad, man.
Oh, really?
He was, Dave Waddle was, a great runner.
Yep. Yeah, he was.
I used to be in the running world. I know all about Dave Waddle. What is he doing now?
He is working at a college down in Memphis.
Oh boy,
exactly.
Doing nothing. Yeah.
So wait, how did he run marathons? I didn't mean to ask the question. Go ahead, you continue with your dissertation. I'll just quietly listen. Sir, did he run marathons?
No. 800 and the mile. Half mile.
What Olympic? I think it was like 72, 76, 72.
72.
72 Olympics, Dave Waddle. Yeah, he was known for, oh, he still wears his hat because he was known for it back then. I see a recent picture of your dad, and he's got to wear the hat still. Enough with the hat. All right, sir. Thank you.
Bye, guys.
Oh, by the way, well, what have you become in life? Oh, that would have been interesting. His father was a gold medalist. What is Scott doing in Tennessee?
Is that why he called?
Yeah, just to say about
his father, you know, had some sex before he won the gold medal.
The night before a big race, apparently the mother crawled in, some type of an animalistic move, and typical in woman fashion, didn't care that he had something to do the next day.
I'm saying it can't happen.
She just had to get what she needed. God forbid he has to go out and earn the bread. No, who cares?
Dave Waddle was very, very famous back in the early 70s. John in Jersey, what's up?
Oh, God. What's going on, guys?
Hey man.
Screw you, I like the Giants. But anyway, you guys didn't get the best part of the whole game. After the game, T.O. crying at a press conference.
We'll play that audio next. Thanks for the setup, John. Thanks. It's Opie and Anthony. The Opie and Anthony Show.
Boy.
Weathermen in the New York area looking really, really stupid today. That's all they talked about yesterday and Saturday, that it was going to be an ugly snowstorm coming through the New York area. I know Boston got their snow. I know parts of Connecticut got their snow. But down here, it was a major, major bust. And they had the crawls during the football games, and they were popping in. They started school closing, last night, getting everyone ready. And then we all woke up, looked outside the window, and went, nothing. There's nothing going on weather-wise. And we got a few more examples of this, because we love just showing you guys how awful the news really is.
How phony and stupid and just ratings-driven and trying to get people to tune in by lying.
I just hope we teach...
Our job.
I hope we teach some of our listeners out there that the news just sucks.
Yeah.
They're fear-mongers. They're very into the culture of fear. And well, a lot of these guys knew that the weathermen. Oh wow, you just threw me off by looking at Katie. What's up?
Who is it?
It's all right.
Sorry about that. I just
Patrice all of a sudden was like pointing like crazy to the TV, and he just it's fine. Katie Holmes, what's up with Katie Holmes? You don't like her? Huh?
That's the point of that. That was the whole reason I just looked at Norton to point it.
She's beautiful though. No?
She was good in one movie. She's not
scared,
anymore.
I'm scared to say. I'm now that scared she's to with say how hideous I think she is because of how powerful Scientology.
You don't think she's beautiful, really?
Oh my God!
I think she's pretty.
I think she's pretty. God, I think she's nuts to be with Tom Cruise and all that. But just looking at her, I think she's a very good.
I don't like her.
Very good looking woman.
She's looking like what's her face there?
I need white eyes.
I
need white guy eyes to even figure it out, man.
And she's tall and lean.
Guys, just I don't want to get.
I think she's a pretty girl. But
I think she's really pretty.
I don't think she's particularly sexy. Like I think she's like I'd like to kiss her, but I don't get sexual thoughts when I see her.
Shirley from Three's Company is better looking.
Shirley Hemphill?
No, Shirley from
here. Put that picture up on
Laverne and Shirley.
Oh, Penny Marshall.
Shirley, the other one. Yeah,
Shirley Feeney.
All right, the short hair might not be doing it, but look to your right there, Jimmy. Put that picture on onaradio.com later today there, E-Rock. You don't think that's hot?
Yeah,
that's a while ago, though.
It's actually a very sexy photo.
That's before Tom Cruise wrecked her.
Kid and Tom Cruise.
Yeah.
She's like nuts now.
When are we interviewing the guy?
Sorry about that.
Book?
I didn't want to interrupt you.
Next week or this week. It's all right. It's not that big of a deal.
Guys.
All I was going to say is that a lot of people should understand that most of these weather guys knew sometime yesterday that this storm was going to be a bust, but there's nothing in it for them to say that on TV because they want you to continue watching their local news for storm coverage, because they've done all their research. They know storm coverage gets a huge rating. So why would they turn around and go, you know what, guys, nothing to worry about here. Go back to the football game. Go back to this. You don't have to tune us in anymore. It's going to just be regular winter weather tomorrow.
And for the morning, like if they scare you the night before, the first thing you're doing in the morning is turning on the news.
Right. And then
see what the storm is all about.
And even when the storm is obviously not happening, they're still not willing to give up on the whole thing.
No.
They suck. We got another example, by the way. So this is what, the local news here in New York was saying about the storm yesterday.
We have several reports this evening on what you could expect from this storm, but we begin with the Eyewitness News AccuWeather team, Lee Goldberg and Heidi Jones, tracking this changing storm. We start with Lee.
Changing.
Sandra, we are in a critical time with this storm right now. It's really do or die. The storm is doing everything it can by strengthening to cool this storm down and change the rain over to snow.
There you go.
Oh, God, what an overdramatic idiot.
And then, of course, we fast forward. This is what they're saying this morning.
On the roads in and around Manhattan, there really isn't an accumulation of snow. But further north, up here in Rockland County, as you can see, there is about an inch of snow on the ground. And on the roads here, it is a mixture of both rain and slush, so drivers really need to be careful.
No, they didn't. Really isn't an accumulation of snow.
Yeah.
You could say
that. There really isn't.
There's none.
Yeah. There was none snow.
None.
None.
They can't say that, though. Because then you're not going to watch.
What's the
It may not be 6 inches of snow, but this storm is still a mess and a danger to drivers on the road heading to work this morning.
No, it wasn't.
To decrease the hazard, salt trucks in New Jersey and New York have been loading up and coating the roads before the snow does.
For the rest of the country listening to us, I can't stress enough. We're looking at, like, just wet streets out there.
Not a bit of snow out there. The temperature on the way in, on my drive in, never got below 37 degrees.
So it wasn't even cold enough for snow, basically.
Nothing was freezing.
Right.
The roads were wet, and that was it. There was no ice. There was no slush. It wasn't treacherous driving. I did the same speed I do every day. Light speed.
Mm-hmm.
It's about, 80.
That's nothing for you.
It's just a wet road.
Right.
All right.
You want to
slow down a little around curves?
You want another example? This is kind of interesting, right? This is what they were saying yesterday.
Because of the storm, we've got alternate side of parking rules suspended for tomorrow. Our team coverage right now continues with Andre Hepkins. He's on the west side with what else the city is doing to get ready. Andre.
Karen, New York City's Department of Sanitation canceled all days off and vacations and called in a whole bunch of people who started about 3 hours ago. They'll work until 8 o'clock in the morning on these roads, and they'll be replaced by people who will start at 7 o'clock in the morning and will work through the afternoon.
And
salt trucks. Yeah. What are they going to do? They're just going to, like, back over edamame?
Right.
Stupid idiots.
Margarita glasses.
I was doing 60 last night in a rage.
Yeah.
Yeah.
In a rage, and I didn't slip once.
No.
But what's the corporate plan behind not just saying, look, we didn't mess up fully. It went to Boston, but we thought it was going to hit here, and God decided it was going to do something else.
God decided they should say
whatever
that.
The case, but they just go, hey, it happens, and
No, they don't want to acknowledge that.
Mm-hmm.
This was it, though. If you look at Boston, this was it, but it just didn't happen.
Right, well, and that's why they moved all the New York weathermen north until they found actual snow, so it looks pretty impressive on TV.
Yeah.
And then you fast forward, this is what they were saying this morning.
And the rain and snow stopped coming down about a half hour ago, but there are dozens of plow trucks here on the roads passing us by looking for any snow that might have accumulated on the road.
They're just looking.
Yeah.
Where's the snow?
And you know what? To make up for it, they're going to have these trucks that just throw rocks all over the street that hit my truck.
Yep.
Mm. I mean, they just sling. I don't even know what they call them, but it's just, it spins. There's a fan at the bottom of the truck, and it just spins rocks everywhere.
And you pass it, and you just see
All right, we got one more. It's worth playing. One more. This is what they were saying about the big storm in New York City yesterday.
The city is bracing for this overnight storm that could wreak havoc on morning rush hour when many of us are heading either to work or school. Christina Penza is live now in Woodside with more on the snow preps. Christina.
Well, you may be able to see some of this heavy rain behind me. It started in just the last few hours. Now, we are here in the parking lot of a home supply store. There were people here tonight preparing for the storm, but others admit to me that they are not prepared. and they could be in for a surprise in the morning.
Yeah, the surprise is no storm.
No storm, no snow, nothing.
And once again, I'll say it. As they're doing that report last night, they knew that this was going to be a bust.
They knew.
There's nothing in it for them to turn their whole opinion around or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
Their whole
you,
what?
It's lovely out.
Yeah.
It's lovely.
Yeah.
For winter, it's not a bad day.
Not at all a bad day.
And then this morning, they changed their tune.
Thank you so much. Well, of course, as we've been reporting, the snow has been limited, but it certainly still could cause some problems for commuters.
Yeah, luckily a lot of people wake up early when they know that they're going to have something that could be affecting our commute. Let's take a look at our rails right now, see if we had any problem with the third rail, snow covering that area.
The LIRRR, New Jersey Transit Metro North, reporting no problems at this hour.
We're
keeping our eye on the rails this morning. Here in front of Penn Station, just a light rain is falling on us. It actually picked up a little bit from the last hour, so we're seeing a little added precipitation, but no big snow accumulations. We did have that
no
heavy
snow at all.
Morning in effect. For New York City,
I hate her guts.
They are, all of them are saying no big accumulations.
And
we're not seeing a lot of snow in the area.
And then someone is panicking in the back room going, we'll check the railroad, the third rail.
All right, the third rails could get covered with snow. How are they doing? No, the rails are fine.
I think you need close to a foot of snow for the third rail to possibly be affected.
Have a problem.
And they knew ahead of time there was just flurry. So why would the third rail be affected? Is this amazing?
They want it so bad.
Does the local news like talking about weather?
They really don't like talking about weather.
No.
They love it! And I love the fact they have team coverage.
Yeah.
Team coverage. Oh. One person's not enough.
No. Team.
Team coverage.
The whole team to get it wrong.
Yeah, well. And then you want to keep going because now we're into this bit.
Oh, yeah. Love this.
This is what they were saying last night.
City leaders are preparing for several inches they say will make the ride on the roads rough. That's why they want people to prepare in each borough.
Mm.
At this Christie supermarket on the west side of Manhattan, Danielle Vreeland grabbed up a bunch of groceries just in case weather causes her to stay home and work.
Yeah, I mean, just breakfast, lunch, dinner, maybe a snack here or there. It should probably pick up some popcorn, or a Blockbuster, something like that.
We have
fascinating.
Five cats, and usually they try to take some.
So you share these donuts with your cats?
Maybe.
Maxwell Aronson plans to stay home and eat these donuts if the fifth grader gets to stay home from school.
As that story was being done, a suicide bomber should have just ran in between all of them and mercifully ended that. mercifully ended that piece. Stupid kid. I give donuts to my cats. I hate you. And I hate the cats. Either one of you should make it to 18.
All right. And this is what they were saying this morning, a little different.
Bad boy.
And we're talking about New York, by the way. We're getting people calling in Boston. You know,
we understand
snow.
Know, you
we
got
know.
Snow somewhere.
We know.
Sure, it's snowing in Siberia.
Being extra careful and preparing for the worst.
Got some salt to make sure the sidewalk is clear.
Mm-hmm.
Got some more windshield wiper fluid so I don't get in any accidents in the morning.
Well, you still do want to use some extra care on the roadways. The roadways are wet throughout a good majority of the tri-state area, and we do still have that snow coming down
in
Connecticut. And, of course, those bridges and overpasses do tend to freeze first. So give yourself a few extra minutes and use
degrees.
Some extra care out on the roadways.
The one person who was standing on snow, there was a moose right behind her. in Canada, lying horse.
They're the worst. All right, one more, and then we'll move on, finally. What did
Sam do last night? All he did was watch the news?
I came in, I go, we gotta get audio of this, because it's just amazing what they do to us every time there might be a storm. They scare the hell out of everybody, and then when it's a bust, they still can't admit that nothing's going on. So this is what they were saying yesterday. This is the final one.
A mountain of salt ready for a city of snow. Sanitation workers prepare to pounce on tonight's winter storm. It's now around 4:30, and all of the city's 353 salt spreaders are plowed up and ready to go. They should be hitting the streets around midnight. New York City Sanitation Department expects the Bronx to be the hardest hit borough. They're ready to shift more of their 3,000 workers there if needed.
I thought we were talking about snow.
No snow at all.
Not at all.
The Bronx has never been more suited for Puerto Ricans. It's sunny, 80 degrees. <it's laughs>
And then finally, this is what they had to say this morning.
We are still watching the snow come down around parts of the tri-state. And in fact, I was just looking at the Times Square camera. Still some flakes flying, even in Midtown. So, yes, we're not quite done yet, but still, it could have been a lot worse had there been more ample cold air. But that just wasn't the case. What we see right now over the east end of Long Island, that's where there are some showers still going for New York. Yeah, that's primarily rain. There's just a little bit of snow in the mix there. Slushy spots on the roadways is pretty much all we're talking about. A coating out there, and that's about it.
There, I gotta make you understand. There's no snow.
None.
None.
You might be confused if you're listening on BCN right now, but we're talking about New York and they prepared us for nothing.
A mountain of salt.
It's wild.
For a mountain of snow.
This lie on God that these weather people did.
Yeah.
Is why I had to get up at 4 a.m.
Mm-hmm.
Cause they thought Norton was gonna be
Norton wasn't gonna make it. Well, Steve, text, are you going to make it?
Well, Steve acts like I was doing a gig on Mount St. Helens.
I was saying, after I found this out, you know, Steve just texted me like, hey, you know, Norton might be,
they were saying over a foot of snow.
But starting
right around the time poor little Jimmy Norton is hitting the New Jersey Turnpike back to New York.
The deep impact media couldn't have kept Norton from Jersey to here.
Yeah. I got the same text at Mohegan from Steve. Are you going to be able to make it? I'm like, I'm on my way to the airport. The stars are out. It's a beautiful evening. There's nothing on the runway.
I would have been more delayed sliding on someone's dandruff than on that snow. There's nothing.
Scroll. Text. Is it okay?
And I got super dark shades, like the shades that just keep, like, you know, Nosferatu, Dracula shades.
Yeah.
So I'm like, oh man, didn't pull the shades up to see this horrible snow. I said, what the? It was, you can see the melt. It just melted. And it was the weak snow that you go, this, it was melting. It was nothing, but I go, whatever.
And they brag about their weather machines and, you know, they got nothing.
I like the ifs.
They got nothing.
But if this line would have come down, we would have seen a lot of snow in our area. It didn't. No,
New York
and there's none.
Never shut down by anything. Snow shuts New York down.
No,
for maybe a second.
Once every 5 years.
It used to. Like they weren't ready for that crap back then. Now that you know, it's not just the garbage trucks that they hook the plows up to. They do. They have a load of plows. They plow the streets really quickly now. It's not like back in the 70s when they were broke and didn't have anything.
Depending on what neighborhood you live in.
Even the bad neighborhoods get plowed pretty quickly these days.
They plow the snow to the bad neighborhoods.
Do they do that?
They push it from Lower West Side to Harlem.
They do that story every year, man, where like in your neighborhood it looks like it's springtime because it's not a hint of snow. And then in some of these other neighborhoods, they're still snowed in.
Where are they going? Come on, let's be real.
On Park Avenue, they helicopter the snow out and dump it in Queens.
You know what? They do that in Times Square. You know what? Day after a snowstorm,
they have a melter.
You can't even tell it snowed.
They have melters
they got to keep that area moving.
It dumps it right into the sewer.
Too much money coming in from the tour. So yeah, Ant's right. They bring
big
out these
heated
melters.
Dump trucks and these big bulldozers pick the snow up, dump it into the heated dump truck, and it melts and it goes down the drain.
All right,
it's amazing.
Steve is
just to keep Times Square going.
He's checking his weather system right now. The Doppler 300. Hey, no precipitation.
I see you being stranded in Atlantic City.
I know. I'm like I was in Florida during a tornado.
There was nothing that could have kept you from New York City.
Well, I actually drove south for a little while, then sped back north even faster.
It's good to have you. We're gonna find out what happened to you at the governor's ass.
Oh, yeah.
We heard that was pretty interesting.
Triumphant return to Long Island.
Also, horses named Opie and Anthony in a bit of trouble.
I saw that on the Google News thing.
We'll try to get to that after the break. And then there was a couple of, what was the other thing? There was another huge story. I can't remember now. And also, did you guys hear about the father who raped his son? And this is a true story, right, Dan? As a punishment for raping his daughter.
Wow.
Wait, the
holy mother of God.
We got the story next, but first, because we promised this and people are getting a little pissed off, T.O. crying.
Son rapes the daughter, father rapes the son.
Yeah.
Everybody wins.
Wow.
I believe so. We'll get to the details of that in just a bit. And Fall Guy?
The aristocrat.
The guy who fell 500 feet?
Ta-da.
The guy who fell 500 feet is now talking, Jimmy.
What's he saying?
He wants to be in rehab immediately because he wants to walk as soon as possible. And the doctor's like, whoa, you got a lot more operations to get to.
What did you say he said?
we'll get into that story. But first, we teased it, so let's play it. It's Terrell Owens having a bit of a breakdown after the Cowboys loss yesterday.
You guys can point the finger at him. You can talk about the vacation. And if you do that, it's really unfair. It's really unfair. It's my team. It's my quarterback. If you guys do that, man, it's unfair. We lost to the team. We lost to the team, man.
You can act like a man. What's the matter with you?
I'm disgusted.
Wow.
There's no crying in football.
You really shouldn't just
about them Cowboys
keep that to yourself.
Ricky
about
Schroeder didn't look up to champ. Yeah, he just looks up to stupid Romo.
To champ.
He's my quarterback.
Shut up.
That was just weird.
It was awful. It was awful.
I don't think T.O. is right in the head anyway.
No, that was
mad. Got all sorts of stuff going on.
It's that same Dennis Rodman thing. Every 5 minutes you're crying about something you shouldn't be. Yeah. All the damage you cause. You're doing sit-ups in parking lots, destroying people's lives, and you're crying over this idiot and Jessica Simpson. And just with big, weird, dark glasses. And
Big, dark glasses on. He was...
Like if you
probably
watch
all
somebody,
puffy-eyed because he's been crying all night.
If you watch somebody, like, you know, do an interview and you go, okay, you read it and you go, I can pinpoint where he was going to cry. It wouldn't have been there. Like, it just seemed like it's just a strange place to cry.
Does he have rage issues?
T.O.?
Yeah.
Nah, he's a different kind of guy. He goes into some weird, defensive, he's like a girl, you know, he's like a weird, like he goes into temper tantrums, which that's what a girl would do.
Maybe he's manic depressive, like Jimmy was saying.
Something's wrong with him.
Maybe, yeah.
Got a little Britney in him.
Because I cry at weird times, too. That's why I'm saying really bizarre.
When do you cry?
Oh, constantly. Weird times.
Extreme Home Makeover?
Never.
Sunday nights?
No. Only if I only cry if they actually get what they want, because I'm disappointed. I want them to make the house worse.
Dude.
Put roaches in it.
I can't watch Extreme Makeover, Home Makeover anymore. They had
you
one
cry?
That's crazy.
You get a little teary-eyed, bro.
I don't know about that.
Look at me trying to convince you asses.
I don't know about that.
There was a family yesterday. If someone could help me out, maybe get some details. I didn't think we were going to talk about this today, but they had a daughter. She was born. Now it's just funny to me. This is where I'm effed up, because last night I was like, wow, this is pretty intense.
What kind of freak was she?
But now that I talk about it, now I have to laugh because it is pretty funny. They had this daughter. She has this disease. Only 25 people in the known world have it. And basically, as a baby, she would run really hard into stuff, fall down, and not cry. And they're like, wow, that's a little weird because she's bruised up pretty bad. And
she
didn't cry at
pain.
All. She would get her shots, wouldn't cry, take it like a man. Nothing. No crying. So they go to the doctor. She can't feel pain unless it's 20 times. So let's say a baby would feel a pinch, right? You would have to pinch that baby 20 times harder than a normal pinch for them to feel it.
That sounds like a superhero. Yeah.
That's fantastic.
That's great.
What they put in the house, a spanking machine? Swings harder than stupid Pop with his big right bicep and his little weak activated left arm.
A refrigerator with a baseball bat with a guy inside it hits her in the face with a sledgehammer and says, don't take this pudding.
Put down the cookie.
A black woman with real pointy shoes.
So
runs and kicks her in the shins for trying to drink bleach in the bottom of the cabinet.
What did you do? I told you. I told you no dessert before dinner.
And nothing.
She went down. Oh.
No crying. No crying. No crying. No crying. Keep hitting me. Say nothing. I'm not going to cry. Nope. Not a tear. Give it your best.
Nope.
Don't feel it. Go ahead. Keep going. Whatever, Dad. Is that all you got? Come on. Yeah. Ooh, scary. All right, maybe a little bit. Tiny bit, tiny bit. Like a little prick there.
She'd run into walls like Herman Munster.
Leave her shape and a silhouette.
But a bad baby.
Can I finish? So then they go to the doctor, and it turns out she has some nerve ending thing where it doesn't feel the pain. But here's the other side of that. You would think not feeling pain would be a good thing. This is where I need help from somebody. Her organs don't know when to cool down or something like that. So if she doesn't keep her body temperature around 62 degrees constantly,
whoa,
her organs could actually just fry,
they overheat
and kill her. So they have to keep the house. The whole family has to be cold.
Oh, what a burden.
That's what I'm saying, man. This is why I was affecting. Like, this sucks. The house has to be at 62 degrees constantly. That's not good enough for her. She has a vest where they put ice packs in it. So she walks around the house with this vest with ice pack to keep her body temperature. I'm not sure how cold the actual body has to be, but it has to be a lot colder than
the person. How much could you love the kid?
I know, her and her dumb hot organ.
And then the brother feels so sorry for his sister that she can't really go outside for a long time, a few minutes. Kind of think Bubble Boy. A few minutes and you got to come back in.
Yeah.
So the brothers decided that he can't go outside and play because she's inside staring out the window at him having a good time.
It's so like he's Edgar and Johnny Winter walking around the house.
Yeah, so he's decided that he will stay in with his sister.
What a guy.
So they built a house because of the medical bills. They lost their house. They were pretty much homeless, and they built this state of the art house for her.
With just good air conditioning?
Oh, there must be some air conditioning in there.
They showed the
everybody freezing. It's like a meat locker.
They showed the temp. It was 61 degrees, and they were all bundled up, and that's how they lived. And she goes to bed with this stuffed animal that they put in the freezer. They freeze up the stuffed animal that she kind of goes to bed with to keep herself.
Put her in the freezer.
To keep herself cool.
That's what I'm saying. Just cut a hole in the... Put her in there like Arnold Schwarzenegger from Batman 4.
Mr. Freeze. I'm Mr. Freeze. Dierks Bentley.
You know, and
Lee Longer.
I used to like Extreme Home Makeover because you get some dumb family. They're down on their luck a little bit. Someone might have lost their job. Maybe a little cancer that they could cure or whatever. But now it's like they're going deep into these diseases you don't want to know about.
Well, okay, you get one disease that bothers you. You can't be bothered by any other one. Just your disease that bugs you.
Patrice talking too much. We'll be back. Opie and Anthony. Jeez. Speed round here. Still lots to do on the Opie and Anthony show. Also, maybe get a few rounds of what did we learn on the Opie and Anthony show today. Want to thank Patrice O'Neill for coming in. PatriceO'Neill.com for all his club dates, arena dates, Super Bowl dates,
podcast.
I don't know, podcast, whatever.
Big game, Opie. Please. Big game. Don't say Super Bowl or we'll get in trouble. You got to say the big game.
Let's call it the big overrated corporate game. If they don't want us to say the other word, that's what we'll call it.
Dopes.
A few other things that everybody's talking about. Well, you're going to be talking about this a little later.
Mm-hmm.
They took a heart from a dead rat, and they got it to start beating again. That's creepy.
Yeah, that is really creepy.
That's a bit creepy.
Also, they, like, grew it, didn't they?
I think they... What,
they took, like, cells and grew a heart.
Oh, so this thing was never
and
alive.
Beats, yeah. They, like, grew one. Why?
They grew one and then got it to start beating?
That's pretty screwed up, yeah.
Why are rats the animal all the time?
I don't know. Just start with people.
Your internal organs are kind of resemble ours somehow, and they respond, I think, similarly
somehow.
Really?
Humans and rats are very similar. Who are you kidding? They just...
It's true. More.
They just destroy
some
everything
more
around
than others.
So we got that going on. Then we got two horses. I don't have the story in front of me, but it happened over the weekend. Two horses, obviously a fan of this very show. The horses are named Opie and Anthony, and they're starving to death. A horrible horse owner. Yes, owners of surviving horses in blah, blah county try to nurture animals back to health. Many viewers were shocked and outraged last night by our report. So this actual audio of this. We got to find this news report about horses starved to death. They chose Never Rest Ranch. All right, whatever. Police An Animal Protective League say they found a total of 5 dead horses on the farm. They are considering cruelty charges against the owner. Of the 20 horses found alive, 4 have been taken to foster homes. 2, named Opie and Anthony, are at the Googa County Humane Shelter.
There's 2 horses named Opie and Anthony.
Lived. You guys lived.
And, yeah, they're alive, but in bad shape. They were on some horse farm where a bunch of horses were starved.
I've heard over the years a fan calling a cat Opie or Anthony, but never like a horse.
I kind of remember a racehorse, though. Like, I think this guy called in once a long time ago.
Really?
Yeah, and said he was naming his racehorse was Opie and Anthony.
Well, he didn't take care of Opie
and
Anthony.
It rings a bell, but yeah, this guy was a skank.
If they were slow runners, so.
Yeah.
They don't
eat. They were horrible.
Change the names of Somalians, Ethiopians.
I guess they're on, I think he's claiming that they're actually on a hunger strike. Swing and a miss.
Yeah.
Also, I ran right into the wall and felt nothing.
Well, speaking of that girl, thanks for the setup there, Jimmy. Talking about that girl on Extreme Home Makeover last night that doesn't feel pain and she's got to keep her organs cool because the organs don't know when to not overheat. Her name is Kayla Woodhouse, and she lacks the ability to regulate temperature, cooling functions, sweating. Don't kick in until her body reaches a lethal high temperature. Her skin is overly dry.
Ew.
You want to know more about her?
I can't wait.
She wears a special vest, is the one I was telling you about, with cold packs in it. She can only go outside to play after sundown. The house thermostat must stay between 62 degrees or below 62 degrees. Let's see, what else? She was diagnosed at 14 months old after passing out on a rare trip to a playground. Her mom said the reason it took that long was a godsend. Let's see. To save Kayla, they first moved the family, which includes Josh, to Alaska.
Because it's cold.
But it turned out she was a racist and hated Eskimos.
So this is what the family had to do to save this girl. They moved to Alaska. That didn't work out too well. Their biggest worry was Kayla running outside in 15 below without shoes, but the state also proved too far from medical centers. A year ago, the family moved to Colorado Springs for the mild climate. What else do we know about her? Swimming is her only sport, and it's good to keep her body temperature in check, but she's limited to private indoor pools. She has horrible allergies too, by the way.
Of course she does.
Church is the only time she's around other kids. They still believe in God? They still believe in God?
Why would you go to church?
I know, Christ is all up there with no shirt showing off. She's going to wear a stupid ice vest and a dopey hat with two cold beer cans in it.
Oh, my God.
Stupid. Old cold shoes. She has to wear those cold pack shoes. All right, but enough of this kid.
I understand you're not supposed to make someone make fun of someone else's faith, but that's where I draw the line. I'm like, it's no God. It's no God if you're allowing this to happen.
Absolutely.
This crap.
Put some lotion on.
It's dry skin.
Just have a living one of those things you shake up.
A snow globe. Just put her in a giant snow globe.
I'm sure she shook her dumb, shaky little... I lost her.
Ah, boy.
You want to know more about her?
I can't wait.
All right. Kayla likes to cook and sew. Even these can be hazardous. She'll start to reach into the oven without a mitt, her mom said.
Of course she will.
That's just stupidity, though.
I feel it.
That's stupidity. That should be an easy one to tell her, look, you can't reach in while the cookies are baking.
No.
Cookies. Everything she eats should have sickles at the end of it.
A frozen pot roast.
Yeah, exactly.
So you can hit her with it when she tries to reach for it too early.
That's a roast sickle.
Her first sewing lesson.
Jimmy's sickle line. Sorry. Piled on.
Her first sewing lesson a few years ago was a disaster. Kayla sliced her stomach with scissors and didn't realize it until blood was spilling everywhere.
Ooh.
She doesn't feel pain until it's 20 to 30 times the normal intensity. She was a fearless toddler. She chomped on Christmas lights. She slammed into walls.
She feels no pain and is completely stupid.
Dude, I was just going to say that. Like,
but she didn't seem stupid last night on the show.
Like,
she's now about 11 or 12, I believe.
I didn't eat Christmas lights when I was a boy.
Huh?
I didn't eat them.
Huh.
Did you?
Think of, though, you know, she's getting older. When she gets legal age, think of what you can do without any her feeling any pain.
Does she feel, you know, pleasure?
I don't know.
Who cares?
Plus, how could you, though, in a 60-degree room?
Dude,
you get a cold shower?
The air conditioning has to stay on year-round. Could you imagine that, Bill? And then, let's see what else she does. Oh, she they have to duct tape socks to her hands so she doesn't scratch too hard. Because she's got such dry skin, she digs at the sores in her sleep.
How about gloves? Why socks on the hand?
Because they're poor.
Oh.
Because they're poor on top of it. How horrific is that?
Kid's awful.
Might not carry it around in one of those puppy cases where her head sticks out. Why even try?
Let's go to Joe in Kansas. Joe?
Yes, I learned today that there is no crying in football, so hand Tio a tissue.
All right, thank you, Joe.
Way to follow it up and finish.
Oh, T-E-E-S-H-U.
Let's go to Tom on...
T-shoe. Damn.
Tom, Long Island, what's up?
What's up?
Hey.
What's up, Jimmy? Can't wait to see you this weekend, dude.
Thank you, man.
What do you got, Tom?
I went to Patrice's show Friday night, and he killed, and he destroyed this table of old people. It was hilarious.
Yeah, it was hilarious. Danny came in today. He saw Patrice at Governor's, and Danny said that it was like a war. Most of the people sat and did what they should do, enjoy the comedian. If you're not enjoying them, let other people enjoy them.
Shut up.
That's all a comedian asks for.
Sit down.
If you're not enjoying
it,
just let everybody else. If the whole room's not enjoying it, then maybe you should be able to yell and scream and do your thing.
It was just, you know what it was? It wasn't even that amazing. It was just some entitled Long Island broad and her beat down husband.
What happened? I heard there were cops involved.
Yes, and one of the ladies.
They karate chopped.
Super rich, and she was karate chopping at the cops, saying, I'm better than you. Hi-ya!
Cops showed up?
They showed up because the guy stood up, the guy Jimmy that owns the place, he finally had to move him away because I was on this guy's wife. Because when a woman's heckling, I don't say anything to the woman. I talk to the guy that goes, does this belong to you? And wait, I just started.
What did she say to start the whole thing?
She's just, anything I said, it's like, yeah, whatever. And I look at
all this loud.
Guy, yeah, all drunk and loud. And I look at this guy and I go, let me show you something about women. And I say, look, she's not going to be able to talk unless I continue to talk myself. She has nothing to say. So I sat there and she had nothing to say. She went, you're just stupid and you're going to bother my friend. So I just looked at her and she finally shut up. So when I talked, then she talked again, and then it was on. So I would have to constantly berate him and berate her through him. I like kept calling her it. Does it belong to you? and calling her man swears, you know what I mean?
I just don't like hearing that.
Yeah, I just called him man. And he said, I didn't come here to watch you insult my wife. I said, so tell her to shut up so I don't have to insult her no more.
Is everyone applauding as you're saying this?
Oh, it was retarded. Must have been.
And is that what that dummy did? He sided with her even though she was
running
her
mouth.
Even
though she was wrong, yeah. Ugh. So he stood up and then he started calling me names and everything. And then he called me a bitch and then said,
Did he go for the, you know?
Go for the what?
The racial angle.
No, he was scared to do that. I think he did that outside. I heard he was calling me all kind of N-words, but not using N-word. The actual.
Sure.
Authentic one. Yeah. So, but he goes, come outside. And I go, I already know you can't even control your wife. You're not going to be able to control me. And then what's the matter with your fists right now? They get better outside. And the crowd starts singing, nah, 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 nah.
But then she had
a friend, of course. You know, ladies always stick up for her. And they just, it was three of them. They just got in my face and she goes, I write for the something, something, something. And I will destroy this place. And the cops came to try to throw her out and she karate kicked at him. She old lady karate kicked, hi-ya karate kicked at him.
It was hi-ya karate?
Yeah, hi-ya karate kick. And said, I will not, you will not, I'm better than you. And it was just, and the crowd, but unbelievably, the crowd, they gave a standing ovation during that whole thing. It was so crazy, but they had to leave. They were poisoned, but it was just this drunk came in with a limo, didn't know who I was, kind of this show's about me. And the guy goes, he says, get him off the stage. And I said, it was
the headliner.
I go, it makes more sense for you to leave than for me to leave because it's It's all over when I'm gone. When you go, it can still go on. Stop being selfish your whole life. Get out.
He wants you to get off the stage and wreck everyone's good time.
Oh, man. Me to go.
Amazing.
Just what pigs. Good for you, man. Yeah. Your fist getting better outside.
I like the part she was doing hi-ya karate, though.
Oh, hi-ya. Hi-ya. Kicking at the Cubs.
Was there security there or no?
No, it was just the guy that owns it.
That's why I bring Kenny. He has a
Long gun. Island, man.
Just
you should have brought the Gavin.
I didn't think I needed it,
6'5", 290, no fat.
I didn't think I needed it, dude. Huh. It was governors was fun.
Did you want Gavin there though when that was going on?
Not even.
No?
They just weren't the type of people I was worried about. They were just rich. Yeah. We run the
title
world.
Brass.
Yeah.
Hey, we're running out of time, but we'll squeeze this in because people will kill us. Dad sodomized teen stepson. Oh, stepson. To avenge rape of his daughter.
Hmm.
Fort Worth, Texas. A father sodomized his 18-year-old stepson to avenge the teenager's alleged rape.
Wow.
Of the man's 8-year-old. Wow.
Let me ask you a question.
Whoa.
Now, sodomy, legally, is not necessarily just, say, flesh on flesh. It can be,
something.
An object. Like,
it's something out of the ordinary of regular, basic sex.
Like the Bible, like sodomy, the Bible is different than the sodomy laws are like if you use something else. So was that like an anger thing? That wasn't a sexual crime. That was like an object or something?
Let's see.
Oh, okay.
Father sodomized his 18-year-old stepson to avenge the teenager's alleged rape of the man's 8-year-old daughter.
Oof.
Wow. The father, 32, turned himself into authorities on Friday and was released from jail Saturday. He posted $17,500. He faces a charge of aggravated sexual assault. This is a tough one, man.
Yeah, man.
In so many ways. Stepson was arrested January 2nd and charged with suspicion of aggravated sexual assault. Police say the father caught him assaulting his daughter, and a subsequent examination at a hospital revealed the girl had been sodomized. This is a very unique case. No, Sherlock. When the stepson was arrested, the man warned his wife not to get the teenager out of jail. She posted bond for the teen's release. So they caught the teenager, and he was in jail, and the mom was able to get him out. When he called home January 3rd after getting released, the father took the call and picked him up, police said. So, wow, he's getting released from jail. He calls home. The father goes and gets him. Wow. Instead of taking the teenager home, the Arlington man drove to an abandoned house in Fort Worth. I didn't know where an abandoned house is. What's up with that?
That's pretty funny.
No, think about
it. Yeah.
I mean, we all have houses in our neighborhoods. How do you know which ones are abandoned? That's a little creepy.
The one with screams coming out of them, apparently.
You're right. Thank you. He beat his stepson in the abandoned home with a baseball bat and sodomized him with a metal tool.
Okay, see, that's not a sexual.
Oh, okay.
Good for him. Good for the father.
After the man left, the stepson found a payphone and called police, who searched the abandoned home. We did find evidence at the scene to corroborate our victim's story.
Wait, let me ask you a question. Was it the kid's father or was it his stepfather?
Stepfather.
So it was the father of the girl, yeah.
So the father and the kid had the mother and the separate father.
Yeah.
Oh, I see. Okay. Ugh.
What a crazy story.
He should have just killed the kid. If he did it, he should have just killed his stepson.
So yeah.
What do you think?
I never had the right answer.
So what do you think happens? The father's got to go to jail now?
No, he won't go to jail.
You don't think so?
That's a rough one.
Extenuating circumstance.
Premeditated, though. He picked him up. It's not like he walked in it. If he'd have walked in on him and did it, but he picked him up, plotted it out.
Brought him to an abandoned home.
Yeah.
We didn't get to shoulder surfing. We'll try to do that tomorrow.
We'll get to that.
Daddy by Queen Ifrika. Some Jamaican song. That's a little crazy. We didn't get to that today. And we didn't get to this sound right here. Maybe this will tease tomorrow's show. Let's see. Really fast. Come on. Yeah. We'll tell you what that is tomorrow.
The old lady after Patrice's show.
Oh, yeah. Good one, Jimmy.
And a karate kick.
PatriceO'Neill.com. Patrice, thanks for coming in today.
Thank you.
It's always a pleasure seeing you.
Thank you.
We're going over to XM. If you're not joining us, right. Have a great day. Bye.
And he'll look at me and we both just kind of know.
Here we are, XM Satellite Radio.
Hi.
And right off the bat, we got to make fun of somebody. And they might be a sponsor. After today, they might not be a sponsor. We got a lovely
A lovely dozen roses in studio.
Yes.
Let me see. Turn them over, Jimmy.
Oh, certainly. Oh.
I'm going to tell you what's good about this and what's bad about this.
Smell good?
Oh, wow. Look at that.
As far as roses go...
Bad.
No, no.
Bad. Bad.
As far as roses go, they're beautiful. Very healthy, very big roses. A dozen what? Red roses?
They're vibrant.
Yes.
I'll take it back.
Count them, Jimmy.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Oh, my God. More. And a few of them are closed, actually. They must have just opened on the way over.
And I think they have been here for a while.
Right, that's what he said. I'll take it back because they've been here.
Yeah, they've been here.
Let me see it again.
16 roses.
16 roses.
A couple of these babies are actually closed up.
With some baby's breath?
16 roses. That is a huge bouquet.
That one in the middle is a nice looking rose, dude.
They're all very nice.
And some baby's breath. They look good.
Very nice. And I assume this this particular company is going to start advertising on the show over here at XM Satellite Radio.
Yes.
Radio.
They are. So I don't think we'll mention the name.
FTD.
All right.
Fuck them. They smell good.
Because they made a mistake.
Nice They're smell. Wonderful roses.
That's what I said. I said, we're gonna tell you what's good about this and what's bad about this. The roses are very, very nice. Look, you can't just pull a petal off. You got to struggle a little bit to get the petal off. Very healthy.
What are you doing?
Here's the problem.
I'm just getting it right.
Oh, you're fixing it up?
Yeah, that's why when what I used to work at a flower stand, you kind of pinch them. And you fix it up a little.
I see it.
Now it looks good.
She loves me.
Go.
She loves me not.
You want to play?
Oh, wow. Well, Jimmy.
Jesus.
Well,
Jimmy.
There goes one rose. Well, here's
beautiful,
the,
actually.
Here's the problem I have with the fact that they sent at least 16 beautiful roses. I mean, really, beautiful.
They cut the thorns?
They sent the flowers to, well, from FTD to Opie.
No.
And...
No?
Nope. Dear Greg and Anthony.
Oh, wow. Ew,
the personal
from the
touch.
Entire FTD family, thank you for your support in working with us. We hope you enjoy these roses. Greg and Anthony.
How the fuck, FTD, and we do like you, because the roses are beautiful. Yes. How the fuck are we supposed to share a bouquet of flowers between Greg and Tony?
Wouldn't you think we'd like to take them home and display them for friends and family, and not just have them sit here at the radio station where they won't be taken care of, they won't be put in a vase, they'll just rot.
How are we supposed to enjoy? Like, I get them, like, on odd days, and Anthony gets them on even days?
Yeah, we have a shared custody of the roses.
Gregorio wants his own bouquet of flowers. So does Antonio.
People think you guys live together, like, and sleep in the same room like Ricky and Lucy.
Yeah.
Like, with separate single king, like, single
live together? That's a Dick Van Dyke couch.
I thought it was going to be like the Beatles in Hard Day's Night. Like, everyone thought the Beatles always were hanging out together.
Oh, I thought A Hard Day's Night was one slumped over in front of the Dakota, hanging out, sneezing with a squishy sound.
Anthony's...
Same joke from last month.
Anthony's had his house for almost 2 years. I've never seen it. I don't think I'll see it anytime
never
soon.
Never seen yours.
You've never been over there?
I haven't.
It's not ready for
I've been to Anthony's... Yours?
Still working on it, yeah.
You have
that's
a lot of people coming over your house.
That's probably why y'all last so long. Good, you know, it's probably best not to.
I didn't have people... People over as like guests like that. I had put people over playing poker, so I have a poker table and chairs in the like dining kind of area off the kitchen. It's not like a let me have people over kind of a thing. It's
bring
some beer.
I'm not a have people over type of guy though. What I'm supposed to sit there and have tea and fucking biscuits?
Crumpets.
I love show business friends. I just love the new way I've learned how to throw the word friendship around.
Yeah.
And it not mean a fucking thing. Me and Norton call ourselves great friends. I talk to Norton every eclipse.
Me and you are good friends. Patrice is a bad friend because he didn't invite me to 4th of July. I was actually hurt
right away. Yeah.
But we're good friends because we have we talk about a lot of very intimate things. We're not surface friends. Surface friends.
I wouldn't call a surface friend. You, Keith, Bobby, I consider my friends. But I think show business, you use it way different than squares do. Like, you don't go. It took a minute for Gavin to understand that we don't talk every 3 days. You talk to your friends every 3 days, or he'll go, "What's wrong, man?"
Yeah.
It's like, I can talk to Norton. Like, like he said, when I did the Def Jam thing, the first correspondence that Norton tried to have with me in the last 6 years was to text me and say he hates my hat. But but over the time period, there is no missing. Like, if I didn't see you guys for 5 months, I wouldn't come back and go, what the?
Hey, how you doing?
It's like Groundhog Day, and you just, time freezes.
Yeah, you just take up where you left off.
We all travel, too, though. The difference is, like, Patrice will be in Texas, and I'll be in Los Angeles.
Yeah.
And then we're back at the cellar on Sunday, and I don't see him for 3 months because he's on the road. Literally is the way it is.
You guys are so self-absorbed. It's not about that.
It's partially about traveling.
You don't really give a shit about each other.
That's not true. But you guys don't. You do a show every day together.
Right.
And never been to his house, never been to his new house. Don't really, you go, hey, let's go to this thing tomorrow. Nope. You're there. You're a Long Island city dude.
Yeah, it's just logistics with me. I would go, but I ain't going to hang out in the city.
But Square Friends don't have logistics.
3 hours of traffic getting home, and I could be home in 20 minutes.
Square Friends do that, though.
Their schedules are a lot of times the same.
Would be times like that. Like New Year's Eve was a blast. And going down to F.H. Riley's, like hanging out.
We didn't hang out.
What?
We didn't hang out.
We were at the same table.
We didn't even talk.
We did.
Are you crazy? We were in the same restaurant.
I'm not saying it in a bad way.
I waved to you when the clock struck 12. You made it sound like we're hanging and clinking beers and stuff. We don't hate each other, but we don't really hang out.
I said I thought we clinked glasses.
No. You were at one end of the table. I was at the other end. Jimmy was in between us.
I was like, "Where's?" Because after 12, I was like, "Where'd Anthony go? You were gone." But I think you were a little buzzed.
I think this
we had a nice interaction.
I think that's the great thing about this business. It teaches you solitary confinement. It teaches you just how to be alone and have tons of friends and still be lonely.
Wait, you really thought we hung out? That's so weird to me.
We were at the same table, and I recall we were talking. At some point about something.
We barely talked.
But I'll guarantee.
And there's nothing wrong with that. I'm just saying we barely talked.
I'll guarantee my interactions with
we were both very busy. Like, I was hanging with my girl
entertaining
and my brothers and stuff. And
trying to get a couple to shut the fuck up.
And you were doing your thing. That's all.
Jesus, it wouldn't stop. You remember them yapping them?
I thought you knew them.
No, I didn't know them. They were fans that just came up and wouldn't shut up. Trying to eat, for the fuck's sake.
I was this close to leaning in being like, this guy actually thinks he's part of the group, and then I was like, wait, he's so comfortable he has to be part of the group.
He was not.
He was part of the group as far as the bill went.
Yeah.
He got a nice free meal and free drinks all night long.
I thought it was Harry and Betty Cumia. Who are these people?
Betty.
I guess he was smart enough to figure it out.
But Patrice, here's the thing. Patrice, I know you like better than I know a lot of quote-unquote square friends. Like, I'm more intimate with guys like him and Bobby and Keith and Colin than I am with people that I would ever know outside the business. Like, I'm more myself and more honest with these guys than anybody.
It's a different... Plus, I get excited to see Norton when I don't see him. Like, it's just a different thing. Like, Bobby will call me every 3 months.
Yeah.
And that's another thing, too, about the business, is that you know how to be friends with people. Like, you know what context, everybody's in a context.
Uh-huh.
And you know how to be friends with them. Like, you know how to be friends with Norton.
In that context.
You know Norton, you have to talk to him in 5 minute intervals, and then he has to go and do something on a computer.
No.
Hey, Norton, how are you? Goodbye, I'm fucking looking at something.
Really?
.com.
Here's shittiest get off the phone fucking person ever. Ever. Okay? So this is Patrice is the fucking worst, because you'll be talking about it, and then he's just done with you, and you know it. And here's how you know. You at the cellar tonight? Just fucking hang up on me. We know where this is going. You don't care if I'm at the cellar tonight.
it is all the same. You're just trying to get off.
Yeah.
You don't want to overstay your welcome with this horseshit. Yeah.
Getting back to the flowers, though, which, by the way, Stephen S. from Bayshore writes, hey, Ope, you should split those roses between Jimmy, his girl, and Tom Chiasano.
Oh, uh-oh. Well, the three.
But
yes.
This is the problem I have with the FTD thing. It was nice that they sent the roses, but how the fuck are Ant and I supposed to split a bouquet of roses?
Eight apiece.
It's just dumb. How?
And then what?
Put them in my pocket?
Yeah. Hold them like fucking Chubsy Ubsy going to fucking Miss Crabtree in my hand.
I would have brought home a nice bouquet of flowers from FTD and displayed them. It would have been nice.
Who's more likely to give his girl flowers, you or you?
I don't know anything about him.
I would say Oak because Ant and his girl are together for a lot
Jesus.
Longer.
Jesus.
I would say because you don't know what
she don't really like flowers. After don't like getting flowers.
Yeah, I don't see her. I would say it's very easy. Opie gets the flowers. And I don't think you would mind.
Well, listen.
But Anthony might want them in his home, though.
No, he doesn't want them in his home.
You don't want flowers in your home?
Do you want flowers, sweetie? I'll buy you some.
Do you want flowers?
But what?
He looks hurt. He wants flowers.
No, he doesn't. I know what.
No, I know Ant, and he knows me. Now, neither one of us could take these home. It's too creepy.
Yeah,
how about
creepy.
This?
So someone else gets them.
Why don't you do this? They'll send more.
They should have sent two.
Of
what?
Course
that's
they
dumb.
Should have. They're just. They're
if I like send flowers,
hold on. The
I
Islanders
fucking sent flowers. Yeah. I ain't gonna give free flowers away. Yeah. They would have just gone to my house and hung out and kind of like fucking you know
no,
brightened up a room. But I'm not gonna present them like fucking.
Oh no, you gotta. If you bring free flowers home, you gotta like start by going, look, free flowers from FTD. I don't want you to think that I just all of a sudden just brought flowers. That's creepy. But let's enjoy them anyway. They're nice. They're, you know, it was a nice gesture.
Like fucking Bradley when he got the stereo salesman's flowers from fucking his whore sister in Fast Times at Ridgemont High
right.
and gave it to his girlfriend.
Right, right.
Like they were, like he got them.
Right.
Are you a plastic tree guy?
What, for Christmas?
No, a plastic,
No.
Just tree.
Real like plants.
Yeah, you're a real plant guy?
Yeah, real plants.
Are you a plastic tree guy?
No, I'm, whatever. I got a real Christmas tree. That's all I have.
No, I'm just saying in terms of...
I live in an apartment. What am I supposed
to
have?
I don't like
plastic
that shit.
Ferns?
What is it? After a while, it's just a dusty...
I don't know, motherfucker. I'm just asking.
Your questions suck sometimes. trying to get all in depth like this
I'm
is
just trying
inside
to
the actor's studio. Shut up!
Who gets it's this flowers?
Neither one of us.
No one will get them now. Someone will just have to fucking take
them. It was a dumb gesture by this company.
You should have sent two.
Stupid.
Should have sent two.
Like, I got interrupted, but the Islanders sent us both. They didn't send one jersey for us to share or squeeze into it together. I got an Islander jersey. Anthony's not a hockey fan, so he got one too, but he's whatever. But
he threw it on the floor.
Could you kick the flowers over? It'll make me very happy.
No.
We should give them to somebody who's
is
like...
Is it in a vase? Can you open the whole thing?
A vase. Yes.
Open the whole
hold
thing.
Hold on. Give me the flowers. Seriously. I want to... Oh, wait on
no,
it
nothing bad.
We should give them to...
I want to decide who
like,
on staff
open
gets
it up
flowers.
And look at if it's in a vase, vase, whatever.
Who's in love?
You know what? I think E-Rock...
Travis is in love.
E-Rock is in
E-Rock?
Love.
I think
E-Rock
you know,
really
the,
loves his girl.
You know, I think all the abuse that E-Rock has gotten over the years. E-Rock, would your girl love these, knowing that?
No, but he's going to give it to a chicken.
No.
he's going to give it to a cutlet.
Wouldn't she love those?
Oh, yeah.
Hold on. She would, Ange would love these, right?
She would definitely love them.
They're beautiful.
You would take them home and display them nice.
Is there a glass vase in there?
Huh?
Is there a glass vase in there?
What's at the bottom?
I want to see if there's like, styrofoam. If it's just stuck in styrofoam or if there's a vase.
You got a scissor so we can open,
yeah, open
styrofoam.
That up.
Give me a scissor.
Why don't you just roll up a newspaper like Luca Brasi's vest?
so
they're
I think,
very nice. They got like white
Ant,
little.
Ant's not going to take them home. I'm not taking them
baby's
home.
Baby's breath or something.
You've taken a lot of abuse what? Lately.
Ooh.
Let me.
Ferns, look at that.
Rex's awful head. It was like a Trojan horse.
Patrice.
oh, fuck. God damn, is that funny. Trojan horse.
That's
it
right.
does.
His head's making me sick.
It's just weird. It's his real hair, but it looks like a hairpiece. It's like, I can't get over it.
It's just bothering me.
Oh, Patrice. That is it. A Trojan fucking horse.
There is no way to style this that would be acceptable to anybody.
No. Sure, there is.
Our
blood
tried everything.
12 gauge.
How about the Kennedy swoop?
you brush it back with a 9mm. and gently part your brainstem. Sorry.
Do we have a scissor? I'm trying to get from the bottom of this thing.
Jesus.
Yeah. Well, the scissor or something. Jesus Christ. I hope we get a scissor.
It really is.
That's,
Puffy.
But why, you know, it's like, send two for the love of God. That way we can take them home and people go, oh, those are nice roses. And you go, yes, you know, FTD sent them. Oh, great. They send one.
Am I going to wreck this if I do the package?
No, you want them to.
Styrofoam.
Oh, it's a nice vase.
Oh, is it? Okay, yeah, I thought so.
Cool. E-Rock, you want these?
Sure, I'll take them.
Oh, no. He's cutting off all the fucking tops on the road.
Is that just making them easier to carry?
Yeah. That's,
You missed one.
That's how Morticia Adams used to do her gardening.
There you go.
That's thanks. Good.
There's your flower.
Now look for the man with the red gun, Asia.
Now put them inside your head and sneak them in the house.
They do smell nice. Mm. Roses do smell nice, don't they?
They're beautiful, but next time send two, please.
Exactly. Mm. Fucking this boy's life hair.
Here, you could have put these in your teeth or something. There you go. Buy your own flowers if you want to bring flowers home to your girl.
Exactly, you leech.
Roses look like vaginas if you squish them.
It's true. Without the annoying fucking nothing wrapped around it. Fucking all emasculating horse.
Are you going to get through the situation with your girl?
I don't know.
Because you're sounding a little grim about the whole thing of you're not quite
clicking. Oh, missing each other? Yeah, man.
Yeah, you're just missing. And
I'd love to blame her for the whole thing, but it's almost like I can't be such a loon that I think it's completely her fault. I can't be.
Are you, because anytime we have seen you two together, you are the picture-perfect couple.
Yeah, we're silly
I'm
together.
I'm thinking, is it, are you, like, just trying to not make a scene?
No.
Or at those times you're genuinely having a good time?
Oh, yeah.
So why, how come every time we see you, you're genuinely having a good time?
I don't know what happens to us. We hit each other on a really personal level. Like,
yeah.
I don't know if it's we have the same flaws or whatever, man, but she can get to me like nobody else alive, and I can get to her the same way.
That's dangerous.
Yeah, man.
Because that's when you delve into that area where there's no taking shit back.
We've never said anything like that. Not
oh,
yet.
You're bound. You're heading for it. Full steam ahead.
Choo-choo.
Full steam ahead on the You're a Cunt Express.
That's take-backable.
Yeah?
Yeah.
What isn't take-backable? And not be specific.
Right. Anything personal, I'd say, about family that was told. Yeah. Anything that's truly intimate. Like, anything that can only be used against you or that I know is going to hurt you, whatever that is.
Yeah, okay.
You know what I mean? It's like, and you both know when you're doing it.
Yeah. Where it's just vicious.
If a girl, like, you argue with a girl and she spits out, and so-and-so is a better fuck.
That would be, like,
true, I'm sure. believe me, being a better fuck than me is no great shakes. It's like being the fucking smartest of the Three Stooges. mediocre at best, but fucking, that's
untakebackable.
Sure it is, because you'd never, I'd think of nothing else when I looked at her.
Right.
Unless she said it in bed while we were having sex, then I'd come immediately. I'd come like the way you snip roses, like somebody snipped to keep the cum in valve. I would come so hard her asshole would have come through. I literally would bust it out immediately.
Holy shit.
Oh, man.
That would turn me out like a light.
All right, moving on.
She said, I need a bigger cock to fuck me. I would just, before she finished, I would go, I would just collapse and I wouldn't even buck. I would just collapse on her and just come as I fell asleep. Come would leak out of me like a rain gutter. None of that fucking thrusting shit.
All right, we got a fine little story here.
God.
Some hidden camera shit.
Oh.
A father finds a surveillance camera in a bathroom. Uh-oh. He and his family had been staying at the Santa Fe Skis RV park for 3 days before discovering the wireless camera. Now he has a lot of questions.
Now, while in the bathroom earlier today, Kimball Kubiak looked up into a skylight and saw a hidden camera pointing down. He immediately called deputies, then he called us.
Enter the men's bathroom of the Santa Fe Skies RV park. To the right, the showers. To the left, stalls and urinals. And up above, perched inside a skylight, a wireless camera.
It's an invasion of privacy. I mean, totally. I mean, I don't. My son, my 13-year-old son's been in there.
Big donkey. You know,
we've both been nude, showers.
Oh, relax. Just let the guy look at your son's
dick. At least the guy's not there doing it. The guy's trying to jerk off from home.
Gives a shit.
Watching it at home.
Take a look if you want. But yeah. Whatever.
You and young dirt digger.
What am I supposed to do? Am I supposed to, like, go take a...
Yeah. Fucking tattletale.
What am I supposed to take a Brillo shower because you want to look at my dick? Gives a shit.
Exactly.
Here you go, buddy.
Take a peek.
Whatever floats your boat. Don't touch it.
Kimball Kubiak discovered the camera this morning after staying at the RV park with his family for 3 days.
You don't know if our little boy's been filmed or what, or if I've been filmed. I mean, it's...
You both
it's
have, just, idiot.
What's going to happen if you were filmed? Yeah. How small is your dick that you're worried about this, sir?
I end up on the internet.
And why are you looking up at the skylight when you're supposed to be pissing, you fucking creep?
I don't want everyone to know that I got one giant ball.
I've did a lot of covert, not showing my dick stuff in my life. Bro.
Yeah.
Really?
Oh, my God.
What do you mean not showing your dick?
Just like in football practice. I'd go home in my entire football uniform.
Running down the block.
I'd be on the bus in my cleats. And my shoulder pads, make sure nobody saw my non-swinging dick.
Oh, man, I was the same way. I was paranoid to take those fucking team showers, man. Fuck that.
Cause there
was some... I'll be sweaty for the last three periods. That's okay.
Ain't you going to take a shower?
No, I don't need to smell good for fucking math class.
They're the mature guys.
Everybody on the team buses in tuxedos. I got my uniform still on.
The mature guys with their big cocks. Is that your problem?
I just didn't have a swinger. It filled up, but it just didn't do nothing.
E-Rock's got a little something on the flowers, yes. Yeah. Did we lose a client?
No, but XM just contacted us. They are a client, and there's supposedly two more shipments of roses coming.
For another Greg and Tony?
It's supposed to be one for you, for Anthony, and for Jim.
Oh,
so there's two more on the tour.
All right, well, because I was the asshole, I don't get flowers now.
Oh, dude, you guys take them. What am I going to do?
I don't get flowers. I don't get flowers.
Who am I going to give them to?
Give me a girl.
And I didn't trash the
the face he makes at me.
I didn't trash the client.
Did you just hear what I was saying?
I said the roses were great. They are.
The roses are beautiful.
Didn't seem smart to send them to Greg and Anthony.
Yeah, we can't share them. We're not fucking gay lovers yet.
All right, more on the paranoid RV guy, worried that someone might have saw his cock.
What a Billy snitch.
Was a camera.
Yeah, but who gives a shit? You're taking a leak, someone fucking takes a shot of you. Who cares?
I don't know if I like that.
If you're looking good, I wouldn't care.
I don't give a shit. As long as the guy's not coming on to me or trying to touch me or anything, who cares?
It's just, you should not have a camera in any restroom.
If there's one visible, who knows if there's anything hidden? I mean,
man on the street stuff, good.
Yeah, you should not have a camera in the restroom.
In any restroom.
Really?
I read that somewhere when I was reading.
I'm all for a four-camera shoot.
Absolutely.
What do you think of that?
I want a ball cam from the floor up.
Right. I want a, what is it, what are they called, best grips or best...
Best boy.
Best boy.
I want a best boy.
Yeah, there's a fucking boom operator behind the guy holding a mic over him.
That's what I want. Well, listen to the man on the street adding a lot to the interview.
Or if I've been filmed. I mean, it's just, you should not have a camera in any restroom.
If there's one visible, who knows if there's anything hidden? I mean, I don't trust, just somebody telling me, no, there's nothing else there.
The Kubiaks called the sheriff's department to investigate and took some video of their own, and the RV park called a city police officer who they say they've talked to before.
They said they spoke to a city police officer who told them that it was okay if they put a camera in there.
Hmm.
No.
Can't be okay to put a camera in there.
Unless they weren't filming people pissed, they were filming loitering activity. I wonder if that's the thing. Like, it was illegally put in.
Or filming all. You know,
yeah, they're just trying to catch guys popping cocks in each other's mouths.
Like Tic Tacs.
Exactly. Just holding it under the tongue like nitroglycerin.
Jesus.
Little clear stuff into the system.
Park manager says it was to catch vandalism. What the fuck? He's worried about his toilet paper?
No.
And his liquid soap? Yeah.
One guy was wrecking another guy's asshole. That crazy vandal writing in graffiti on the guy's back with a load. Wash me. with fucking common blood.
Spelling West Side. Spelling MS-13 and fucking cock
and
juice on your neck.
Common blood and shit.
Crazy vandals.
Sheriff Greg Solano tells us park managers admitted to putting up the camera, but say it was to catch people breaking into a cleaning cabinet underneath a sink.
According to the owners, they were having vandalism and theft in those cabinets. Is where they keep bathroom supplies, toilet paper.
So put the camera in the fucking cabinet.
It doesn't look like
as tall as someone opens it at their face.
Right? Yeah, really.
Get a sky cam. We were trying to get the Hubble aimed at this fucking rest park.
Yeah.
Like to see what they're stealing if that 13-year-old's cock wasn't in the way.
Yeah. What are you taking, toilet paper? What's in a fucking RV rest toilet? It's,
instead, they got a telescope in the toilet trying to catch vandalism.
Supplies, toilet paper.
Solano says so far it doesn't look like intentional voyeurism.
I think the city officer misadvised them. On this case, and you know, we've told them that they need to take it down, and they said they would immediately.
You walk nude all in there, whether it's at the sink or not. So it shouldn't matter whether it's at the sink or where it's pointed. There's still a camera in the restroom.
Okay, he's not letting go.
Yeah, no. He's obsessed.
Mike from New York. Mike?
Mike from New York. How are you?
Hey, buddy.
Mike.
If I can't get 4 ounces of sausage in a package, by God, I'm going to film it in this RV park.
It sounds similar, right? To sausage guy.
The sausage.
Sausage.
I don't want my son's sausage.
Sausage.
Videotape.
A 16-ounce package.
Package.
Sausage. I hate that.
I hope he bit into a sausage and there was fucking glass in it.
All right, so that's going on. Whatever.
Cute story.
Hey, quick break, but before we go to break, we want to remind people, actually, I don't think we started promoting this, right? We start today. Couples Cherry Darts coming soon to the Open Air.
With a twist.
With a twist. We got a date set and everything.
Oh, wow. Saying anything. I wouldn't say a word.
What?
About the twist.
What's the twist?
It's only gay couples.
There's a twist to this?
Yeah.
The grenade launcher?
You know? Yeah. Like you get ready, and then it's like, not.
Yeah. They're really cherry bombs.
Eh. And then, going, wham.
Hey,
how's that?
Very good. By the way, no wonder no one laughed at my joke. It's a periscope, not a telescope. Fucking dope I am.
Oh, out of the toilet.
Couples, see, now it'd be funny. What an idiot.
Now it's interesting.
Now it's almost funny. Fucking
submarine
telescope.
Is in the toilet.
A telescope in a toilet bowl. Yeah, whatever. Hey,
no worse than my fucking cherry bombs joke, which just fucking went through the fucking... You missed that one?
I did.
Oh, boy. It's apparently everyone in the studio and the home audience did as well. It was a monumental dud. Fired out. It was a verbal clunker. It was a fucking... It was a verbal jalopy. The Edsel of jokes. It was fucking the Windows Vista of improvs. Fucking... Oh, it was awful. It ran right into a wall and bounced off like a fucking hot-livered little fucking creepy kid. Old toaster guts. I've had enough of fucking old oven guts.
Oh, McDonald's cherry pie filling guts.
Had enough of that stupid kid and her 20 times the pain. She doesn't know she's not supposed to fucking eat Christmas bulbs. Yeah, then fucking kick her out.
Oh, kick her into the hot sun.
What is she going to get married and have a fucking real family?
Oh, fucking burden.
Yeah, who's going to fuck her? You have to put a little warmer on your dick. Put a dick glove on so it stays hard in 50 degrees. Fucking creepy Mr. Freeze bitch. Kid sucks. Fucking get a frozen coat hanger and fix that. Yeah, what a bad girl.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Fucking.
You got to fuck her with popsicles.
old lava cervix.
Oh. Oh, my God.
I'm fucked up.
Old Sahara pussy. Nobody wants that.
No one needs that.
Nobody wants that hot pussy.
Fucking radiator ass.
I would like to understand, because last night I had teary eyeballs. Today I think it's the funniest thing in the world.
Hilarious.
Yeah. Whatever.
Bouncing off walls. What a dopey kid.
By the way, getting back to the RV hidden camera story, someone suggests on Instant Feedback, Dan C. from Pottstown, PA, wouldn't a lock work?
Yeah, how about locking it up? No, it wouldn't work because then you couldn't see people in the bathroom.
Or how about just a sign, camera installed, even if there wasn't one?
See, the guy thought it out, though. He's like, okay, if by chance I get caught, I could always say it's because I got supplies in this cabinet. Yeah. Oh, yeah, of course a lock would work, but like Ann just said, then he wouldn't get to see young
Maybe it's a rotating camera that he can aim wherever he wants, so at the end of the night, right back towards the camera, towards the cabinet, in case they find it.
Very good.
Who knows?
All right, Cherry Darts. It's happening on January 31st. That's a Thursday. It's already penciled in and ready to go on our schedule. Cool.
Cherry Darts is fun.
We want to thank BodogLife.net. They have supplied $2,500. BodogLife.net.
Righteous bucks.
And we'll split it up, first and maybe second prize. So I will figure that shit out behind the scenes. But at least $1,000, way more than $1,000 cash to the winner of Cherry Darts. Basically, you come in here with your gal, talking to the guys, of course. Or maybe we get a lesbo couple. You never know.
Or a gay couple. Let's be all inclusive.
Oh, God.
I would love that.
What? Ugh.
You kidding me?
What?
A gay guy lobbing a cherry at the asshole of another gay guy?
What?
Who wouldn't enjoy that?
What?
I would love it.
What?
I do think it would be advantageous to them.
Who's
the target's bigger.
Of course. That's true. We have to get them bowling balls painted red.
Get spit back out along with the stem tied in a knot.
Bowling balls one went nowhere.
Okay, I'm sorry.
Bowling
balls.
Painted red. I thought that would be a fucking hit.
It is funny.
I actually slid into the room with my arms open.
Ta-da.
Hey. I thought you'd go to different fruit. Like pomegranate darts. Wind up like a softball. Hit his catcher's mitt, asshole.
Well, how about cannonball darts? Just fucking...
So, the girls will be across the room. Naked, bending over.
We're guys.
Girls. Okay. And then their boyfriend, their husband, their
partner, life partner.
Girl lover. Get darts, cherries. With little whipped cream on them.
Ooh.
And they go for the bullseye, which is the anus.
Closest to the anus.
But I think we're going to make a whole dartboard on their butt side.
Yeah, that way we can
And then we'll have point system. And then whoever gets the most points after, I don't know, 10 rounds or whatever, how many we feel like playing, and they're going to win a lot of money from BodogLife.net. So if you're a couple and you're interested in doing this, you got to email Travis at foundrymusic.com. FOUNDRY music.com. Okay? Travis has Jim's bomb. Oh, I got to hear this now. This is Jimmy from a mere 2 minutes ago.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Take shelter.
couples cherry darts coming soon to the Opie.
With a twist.
With a twist. We got a date set and everything.
Oh, wow. Not saying anything. I wouldn't say a word.
What?
About the twist.
What's the twist?
It's only gay couples.
There's a twist to this?
Yeah.
Bomb number one. A grenade launcher?
You know? Yeah. Like you go, you get ready, and then it's like, not.
Yeah. They're really cherry bombs.
Yeah. And then,
Oh, God. Wow.
Oh, wow. Oh, were you throwing them?
No, he wasn't. He was doing that subliminally.
Yes, the humor went right under the fucking mat.
I kind of whispering them in the background.
Home. Well, I didn't want to, just blur it out. I just had to throw out little lines. How could I have confidence? Three in a row. Strike one, strike two, strike three. Strike one, strike two, strike
You're
three.
Out.
John in Virginia is saying gay cherry darts equals Howard Stern bit.
Oh, all right. Well, I don't listen to Stern,
That's bullshit. We've been doing the cherry dart thing for years.
Never heard of it, sir.
Yes, sir.
We do it with
That's
chicks.
What I'm doing. I'm stealing from Howard on the air.
Yeah, well, that's what we're doing. Couples cherry darts happening January 31st. Once again, $2,500 up for grabs. BodogLife.net. Thank you. Email Travis at foundrymusic.com if you want to participate, okay?
Right.
Oh, this makes me cold.
I decided to, I know.
might have to put my jacket on.
I decided to go to the movies yesterday, and...
Ooh, what'd you see?
And once again, I'm like, why do we have to go to fucking movie theaters to see movies in this day and age? But whatever. I finally saw No Country for Old Men.
Yeah.
No Country for Old Men, yeah. It was all right. It was all right. No one's seen it here, though, right? Dan, you saw it? Dan loved it, right?
I didn't see it. A lot of people giving it raves.
I liked it a lot. Sam is even more of a fan.
Why?
The ending bugged me, which, of course, we won't get into. But Sam thought it was brilliant.
He thought it was brilliant?
Yeah.
Sam's kind of an idiot.
Yeah, he's a dummy. He watches wrestling. What the fuck does he know about Coen?
I know, yeah.
It was a really good film by the Coen brothers, but, I don't know. They're saying it's like one of the best movies in a really, really long time and all that, right? I'd give it 3 stars.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was good.
A
lot of good violence.
Rotten Tomatoes?
What did Rotten Tomatoes give it?
Your 3 stars?
Something awesome.
Like 70 or 80, I bet. 80%, I'm going to guess. Mm. On Rotten Tomatoes.
I say 71.
93.
Nope, 93.
Oh, 93. Wow, Patrice.
How do you know?
How's that sandwich?
He just guessed. He guessed and it was right.
It just was a well-loved movie.
Yeah.
Me and Patrice had a moment on the other side, by the way, that we just, I guess, both decided not to bring on the radio, and now I'm bringing it on the radio. I'm such an asshole. Kenny gets everyone's food, and he plunks down like so much watermelon in front of you, all cut up nice. And I looked at you, and you looked at me like, yeah, I know, it's very stereotypical, but I just like watermelon.
It's good shit. I love watermelon,
We just
too.
Had this weird moment, like, we both acknowledge how ridiculous it was.
I will not let, what's his name, D.W. Griffin movie stop me from fucking I don't give a fuck how big the bug eyes was, and fuck that.
I just
enjoy watermelon, and he can't help but look, because I understand. It's just like if you have an Asian friend that just
like
does everything with chopsticks,
right?
Like I'm just gonna, and you just go, what the fuck are you doing? So I guess a black guy.
I never liked watermelon, hated it my entire life.
Watermelon,
it's delicious, stuff. Man.
Yeah.
And every time I try to bite into it, I'm like, how is something so wet but tastes so dry at the same time?
It's the best.
It's so
stupid. I wish I had enough stupidest. Balls to come in there and have Kenny bring me the whole one that I could just chew down to the rind and eat it like a back and forth. Zone.
Right. Like in the cartoons.
Balls, you should see how I eat watermelon when no one's looking.
You need a bib, right?
Oh, my God. Al Sharpton had me killed. That's first on the agenda.
But it's sugar water, really.
I eat watermelon like the 20s.
It's all fucking water.
Yeah, but then it tastes dry, though.
Does it?
It's weird.
I love that.
Whatever.
I just eat one bite of watermelon, and I get one of those fucking seeds in my mouth, and I want to just throw it out the window.
That's what I don't
Slimy
like.
Seeds, too, on
seeds
top of it.
Seeds piss me off in anything.
It was just a dumb, stupid moment that we both kind of acknowledged secretly
to
each other.
I didn't even say anything.
Anyway, on Rotten Tomatoes, again, 95%.
One movie got a zero.
A zero?
Miss Call, the remake. Because, you know, for some reason we...
That's a remake? It's based on cell phone technology.
There's no movie, no horror movie now,
Japanese.
American, that's not copying the
They're all Japanese movies.
Miss Call is a Japanese movie that was very scary.
Yeah.
This got zero.
Oh,
this,
wow.
I think it might be the only zero in history.
Well, Dan will look it up when he gets back in
it
here.
It follows that whole theme of, if you watch the videotape, you'd fucking die, and if you do this... play a video game, you die, and now it's a cell phone call, and if you get the cell phone call,
all Japanese,
and some idiot in Hollywood or wherever was like, look, man, everybody's using cell phones, why don't we try to get a movie where we scare the shit out of everybody that uses cell phones?
Didn't work.
Jessica Alba's movie.
What rating did that get?
The Eye.
Miss Call or whatever it's called.
The Eye, right?
Hey,
got shit.
You want to guess what the number one movie at the box office was?
Miss Call?
National Treasure still?
That fucking National Treasure 2 did well again. Fourth place.
What's the total on that fucker?
$11.4 million earned.
What's the total on that thing?
I'm starting to think I might have to see this dumb movie.
No,
how much money?
There's movies that get hyped up and they do very well after the first week, then they die fast because people didn't enjoy the movie and they're not
just went, oh.
And they're not telling their friends. But this National Treasure 2, week after week, is doing well.
But you know what genre it's under? It's under family. It's like a Pirates of the Caribbean movie.
I like the Pirates of the Caribbean.
They make a lot of money, dude.
Hey, what's missed call? One missed call.
Big grand total of zero.
Zero. Mm. I think that's the only zero in history, right?
And wait a minute. 53 reviews. 53 reviewers across America said this movie blows.
Wow.
Is that the lowest rated? A zero?
It has. Well, yeah, it's the lowest rating. I know.
But I don't think other movies have gotten a zero.
That could be the first movie that went zero, huh?
Not one person has enjoyed.
No,
So National Treasure 2 is in fourth place. So what's the guess? The top movie of the weekend?
I do, Opie.
All right. What's your name, sir?
I'm Jimmy.
Hi, Jimmy.
Hi.
Isn't your name Yee-Yee?
Oh, yeah.
What did they, what movies came out? Let me think.
I say I Am Legend is number one.
No.
I Am Legend, it's been out a while. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 place, 8.1 mil.
Okay.
I'm going to see it on that big giant screen, whatever it's called, the real big one.
Yeah, Max.
Yeah, I'm going to that.
Sweeney Todd.
No.
Sweeney Todd didn't even make top 10, it looks like.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
No top 10 for the Sweeney Todd.
It's not that
tough. Oh, one missed call because we mentioned that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7th place.
The Will Ferrell movie.
There's no Will Ferrell. Such a dick. Got you that time. I was ready to look. Wait, Will Ferrell movie.
Will Ferrell.
Anybody else?
It's not a cartoon out, right? Right now? Pirate something?
Mm. Oh, the vegetables one?
The pirates who...
No, that's religious.
There's a movie called The Pirates Who Don't Do Anything. What's that about? Is that
veggie thing.
Really?
They're all... It's religious.
What? What?
That veggie series that they made a movie about, but it's also on videos and stuff for kids. It's got all kinds of religious undertones to it.
Really? Veggie?
Yeah. They try to...
A lot of God lessons, Z-Rock.
Yeah,
saying.
Yeah. It's like fucking, David and Goliath. When you're watching David and Goliath as a kid, you never really got into the whole religion part, but you always like, my God always comes up in this shit. You know, the father always go, that's God's way, Davey. Oh, gee, Dad, you know, why did that happen? God has a plan for us, Davey. And you're like, you don't pay attention to that. But all the rest of the show, they kind of hooked you in. Like, oh, look, a puppet, the talking dog, the whole thing.
Yep. Sally.
Sally with the yodels on the side of her head. She had the yodel hairdo. And the father with the Jeep where his head stuck out higher than the roll bar.
Goliath with his fucking oven mitts. So when he fucked Sally, he wouldn't scratch up her sides. When Davey would grab his fucking, his God-inspired pink Goliath dog dick, fucking stroking it to Sally's face.
Don't do it, Davey. Well, so that's the Pirates who don't do anything? Came in 9th place, Atonement, 10th place, P.S. I Love You. Anyone seen these movies? 8th place.
Yeah, bah.
Alvin and the Chipmunks is still doing well. 5th place.
Wow, really? Million.
There's another kid cartoon out. It's a cartoon.
Is it The Orphanage?
No, it's a cartoon.
Right.
Wait, they're saying it's VeggieTales is the name of that movie?
Is it?
It's Veggie of Tales. The VeggieTales series.
Oh, all right.
Oh, boy. This is good.
Come on, Jim.
It's the cartoon that's out. It's a children's cartoon. It's called A Tumor for Sven.
What the hell, Jimmy? Third place is Juno. I saw it. I liked it. It was all right. First Sunday was in second place. That got horrible reviews. Tracy Morgan and Ice Cube.
Oh, yeah, real bad.
It got really bad. Why did Tracy Morgan blow us off this time around? What's up with that? These people are weird, man. Roland! They're like good friends of the show, and then all of a sudden they blow us off when it comes to the biggies.
That's how Roland walked over from CBS to here.
Yeah,
just like that.
Yes, no.
What?
He doesn't believe in winter coats.
It's fucking cold out.
He doesn't believe in winter coats.
Nope.
Just t-shirts for a
Not only doesn't believe in winter coats, you could wear like a fucking hoodie or something.
Long sleeve shirt.
And you'd still go like, what are you crazy? But he wears short sleeve shirts outside.
Do you run into walls and feel no pain?
Yeah. Is that something? Are your guts like a furnace?
That's what it is. Old fucking, he's got that heart disease. He takes molten shits.
and when he's walking out there, he sweats.
Yeah.
Which is just really weird. Yeah. Something's going on with you there, Roland. So, Roland, why no Tracy Morgan?
The film company had a schedule, and they only...
But Tracy's a friend of the show. Wouldn't you just get to him and go, Tracy, hey, what's up? Yeah. You guys want to see it?
He missed 2 days of press because he overslept, so... He's going to come back, but not during the movie, though.
Yeah. No. Not during the movie, though, no.
First Sunday, you see it?
Yeah, no.
Why?
Why not?
It's awful.
Did you like No Country for Old Men?
Yeah, but There Will Be Blood is way better.
What movie?
There Will Be Blood.
There Will
they
Be Blood.
They said that fucking pussy, that pussy can act, but and he's not famous.
Who?
Daniel Day-Lewis.
He does nothing
he
but
pussy?
Act.
What's There Will Be Blood?
Well, I'm not saying he's a pussy, but I'm just saying he's that it's an oil movie.
Yeah, Daniel Day-Lewis, he's phenomenal.
That fucker can, goddamn, he can act, man.
Who's
Daniel Day-Lewis and Paul Dano.
He was in My Left Foot, Daniel. He won an Oscar, I think, right?
Mm-hmm. That was 75 years ago, but he's still...
What's this movie about, and why haven't we seen it yet? It's not out yet?
It's out. It's really good. It came out on something.
And what's it about?
He's like an oil man, and...
delivers oil?
No, well, he's like looking for oil,
oil
and
man.
He found the wells and how his riches become. Like, he's a rich guy now, and... Really paranoid about people.
Yeah.
It's really good.
Action, adventure, intrigue.
He only plays motherfuckers from 1801 to 1906.
Certainly has nothing new.
Let's see what the film takes place.
Nothing new.
But it's really, really good.
When he first started finding out parakeets die in mines before people.
Did you see the number one movie over the weekend?
Which one?
That would be The Bucket List.
Yes.
Ah, damn.
Oh, fuck, that's right, and I knew that. Because
that didn't get good reviews on Rotten Tomatoes, man.
It looks so
it got average
stupid,
reviews.
And like one of these fucking buddy movies where they're dying.
It is, and they find each other, and then...
Yeah, I'm sure it ends all nice and fucking... No, I mean, they die and shit, but I'm sure it ends with them accepting the fact that it's going to happen. They had fun, and fuck you.
It's a weird ending, though.
Well, it's about new experiences, right, or whatever, or things they never did in their regular lives.
Morgan Freeman can't afford
Lemon
it.
Party right before they die?
So do they suck each other's dick?
Almost, but
did Morgan Freeman finally admit that Jessica Tandy was a cunt and she would shit her diapers while they were making the movie in the car and he hated her? It was just to leave the back windows open.
Who dies first?
That'd be Morgan.
Morgan, and
then he
does Jack get all choked up about it?
Yeah, then whatever Morgan asks him to do, he finally does it. He goes, "This is for you, buddy." And then
what'd you do, burn the script?
No.
Old men, cocksuckers, do a real movie.
It was pretty bad.
And then what? And then he dies?
His last request is to punch that baby hard enough for her to feel it.
Oh, he meets his daughter, what?
He meets his daughter, and then he reconciles.
That he didn't have time for when he was like...
That's great.
And then they both have like little urns, they punch top of the mountain, his assistant, and then they...
Yuck. Yeah.
Little urns for him and Morgan?
It's like fucking dead Brokeback Mountain.
Yeah, but There Will Be Blood is like the best one out right now.
Yeah. I can't quit you when he's talking to the radiation.
Oh, shit.
Old Puddinhead.
Hey, Roland, we're all seeing Cloverfield tomorrow.
I know, I'm excited.
What's the buzz in this movie? They're not showing us much. No one really knows what it's about.
Nobody's seen it, really.
I heard, can I tell you what I heard, or is that really bad?
Might be bad.
You know what I'm going to say?
Let's see it first and see if it was accurate.
All right. Yeah, maybe I shouldn't blow it up. I'm hearing, whatever.
It's black people?
Patrice, they are killing you on answer feedback with the eating today, but I just want to let you know.
Fuck them.
That's not me, though.
It was before.
Oh.
That's just here. That's Patrice.
It's Jimmy eating pretzels, too.
Patrice is tipping, and me.
Jimmy's eating pretzels.
So Cloverfield, what do you think? Is it going to be good, bad, indifferent? What do you say? What are you hearing? We're going to have what? Abrams on?
He's in a call either Friday or Monday.
What if we see the movie tomorrow? Jimmy and I were discussing this over to XM.
Mm-hmm.
Coming over to XM. A lot of us are seeing the movie tomorrow, and what if we just fucking hate it? Then what happens?
Oh boy.
Well, they got to be smart enough to give us a screening of a movie they're pretty confident is going to do well.
Yeah,
everybody
is.
We didn't get a screener. We didn't get a special screening for One Missed Call, obviously, which is just a bomb.
Yeah. No, they're confident with the movie. It's going to be. There's really nothing. This week is 27 Dresses and Cloverfield. That's pretty much it.
All right.
But I think it'll be good, though.
Cloverfield's supposed to be this big mystery surrounding it.
Yeah, you don't know what the hell the monster is.
Is it
or
a
something.
Monster?
It's got to be a monster. The head of the friggin' Statue of Liberty goes flying down the street.
Always
going to do that.
Posters are shit.
Always. I'm so fed up with the Statue of Liberty being raped in every movie. It's just...
Started with Planet of the Apes.
It had to start before. And it's the end of the world. It ain't even just the end of America. The Statue of Liberty represents, what a dress-up. Her pussy showing, somebody's finger fucking her.
Just fat lips. Big fat green lips.
Her book is all fucking floating away and her crown is all...
It is always the symbol of everything's fucked.
Yeah. It's the Statue of Liberty. But what is this movie? What's the genre?
Is it a horror film?
It's kind of like a suspense action movie.
But it's also like a Blair Witch kind of a thing because it's done with people that are involved during the story, handheld, cell phone cam kind of look. So you're supposed to be
they're documenting their last.
Involved. Yeah, they're documenting kind of what's going on.
Kind of Blair Witch Project.
Camcorders and... Yeah,
I think that's pretty cool though. Hopefully it'll be
done
right.
Sounds like a cool idea. I hope it's good.
Yeah, we'll see tomorrow. And they're doing all that viral marketing. Ooh, that's really hot these days.
Mm. I heard they opened the Statue of Liberty's book and there's just pictures of things in it, and they realized she was a retard.
It was a Dr. Seuss book.
all the dicks she fucked when she was in France. All the dicks she sucked when she was in France before she got here.
It's a bunch of guys with fucking white wigs and those little brown moles. They're fucking unclipped fucking scurvy dicks. 1720.
With their wood teeth.
Yeah, wooden teeth and scurvy dicks.
Spike marks on their stomach from getting blowjobs from it.
With their shiny moles that they powder up nice before they go out.
Her unshaven iron pussy.
Hey, Roland, did you Juno?
I love Juno.
Juno was good, right?
Mm-hmm.
Soundtrack was pretty interesting.
Yeah, it's good.
You want to play Superstar today? An old Carpenter's song that... Who did it in the movie? Sonic Youth?
Yeah, Sonic Youth.
See if you got Sonic Youth doing Superstar. We'll do something a little different. We'll go to break with that song. Let's say hi to Rich in New Hampshire. Rich.
Hey, what's up, Opie? I'm just calling because I went and saw Juno based on your recommendation, and that scene you were talking about all babies want to be born, I totally agree with you. You guys should be able to say that shit on the radio.
Just say thank you and hang up.
Thanks a lot, man.
Thanks, man.
Oh, the Asian that was protesting outside the abortion clinic, and she was protesting in broken English because she's Asian.
Yeah, exactly.
It's okay if you do it in movies, but on a radio show, it's not, for whatever reason. Okay, now I know what you're talking about. Yep.
The scene was hilarious, but if you guys had said that on the radio, you guys would have been picketed and thrown off. It was ridiculous.
We'd have been in Dutch.
All right, sir. Thank you.
All right, later.
Oh, boy, that's not nice. Large Mick, Big Huge from Kentucky writes, the Statue of Liberty is a size queen.
I know.
She sits right down on the Empire State Building.
She would only fuck warlords from Africa. The French dicks did nothing for her. She's a big grass skirt cock.
She takes the Empire State Building right down to the sidewalk. Right down the old sidewalk.
Oh, my God. That's some gold shit right there. Oh, that's almost... She takes it all the way.
And she's so bummed because she looks toward the Twin Towers and they're not there anymore. She was taking both those towers in both holes. No problem.
Her
right down to the sidewalk.
She wants the Freedom Tower for the shitter.
Right to the Superstar.
All right, you want to hear a creepy version of Superstar? You would know the song. I think the Carpenters did it originally. Did we got the original? Play me a little taste of the original. This is one of...
Little taste, that's funny you say that with the Carpenters.
Yeah, really.
She didn't taste much of anything except her own vomit. Nothing? Died of anorexia? No? Karen Carpenter.
Oh, God, yeah. Karen Carpenter.
Yeah. All right, I'm making Karen Carpenter puke jokes. I thought I'd get a little laugh. Fuck.
Here's the original.
It's a laugh-free zone today.
Everyone's
Jesus
fucking
Christ. Well, everyone's just bombing.
Holy shit, but no one should be.
Pilot to Bombardier.
That's what's bothering me. It's like, that's bombing. Funny. I think that reference, it was so, it was way beyond.
Well, the only reason I brought it up was because, you know, we're going to play some Carpenters.
I just didn't get it. That's all my own problem. Yeah, I did not get it. But now that I do get it, I would have laughed.
Dan would have laughed at that one.
Of course he would have. Just suck up.
Michael Savage, send tickets. Yes. Blue Line, Islanders Flyers in Philly. Yes, I'm there.
Michael Savage, the radio guy?
I don't know.
I saw a trailer for a Western last night, and I was thinking, Dan would be perfect for a Western these days.
Didn't require acting.
Like you. Oh, shit.
Well, we'll never know because of this program.
Oh, wow.
Steve, quick, text. Make sure he doesn't insult the staff.
He's being insolent again.
Yes, he's being insolent.
By the way, last Comic Standing this year?
No.
Why?
Why?
I didn't know about it.
I want to see Dan act. You should do a comics.
Yeah, you should. Maybe you should have done a commercial.
All right, listen.
Pretending to rap. It wasn't.
Listen to me.
What?
Eastside Dave just got fired. That's why Don was in town today.
What happened?
I don't know what that's about, but he just got fired. Because
he smashed Fez's face into a pizza.
Trying to find out more info, but that's all I know so far.
Did he really? Are you joking?
No. He's gone. That's why Don was up today.
You just never know on their show what's real or what's a fucking work. That's what's amazing about their show. Sometimes you're just like, this is all fake. Like the whole fucking Dave getting married thing.
Right.
I thought was a wash up until I fucking was there
watching it.
And they got married.
Did he? I'm sorry to interrupt you. Did he hurt Fezzy? Because I heard the end of the show.
Yeah. Fez left.
Because Fez is a very sensitive guy, but did he physically hurt him?
I think he did. Like he hurt his eye. It was like Slave Boy Week or something, and Ronnie didn't think the bit was working. So I guess they were trying a little harder to make something work, and he had a collar on. He was treating him like a dog, and he made him, like, sniff a pizza that was on the floor. And while he was doing it, Dave took the back of Fez's head and smashed it into the pizza. But, you know, it's a fucking floor. How much give does a pizza have?
Right.
So he, like, hit his eye, and then he just got up and ran the fuck out of here, I'm sure, in tears.
No,
into the rain.
He had a few things to say before he left.
Did he?
Had a little breakdown.
I didn't hear that.
I was actually listening.
Dude, I didn't hear that.
Thing.
I missed I turned on the fucking end of Ron and Fez, and I hear something going on, like where Ron was scolding Dave.
And, you know, HR got involved, and Don was up here. I was wondering why, and that's it.
I thought they had reviews.
That's it.
But
so, we'll try to find out
Jesus.
More. Also...
Oh, she's got a baby on the way
they
and everything.
They fired Dave?
Jesus.
Was he fucking up? I don't know anything about the show.
Everybody on that show except Ron Bennington fucks up. That's pretty much what I've gotten
Ron's
from the show.
Ron's a rock.
Ron is a rock.
That was the final straw, I guess. I don't know.
Oh, maybe we'll he messed up? I don't know much.
The other thing that was suggested by a listener, I think it's a great idea. Anthony was ranting and raving, losing his mind with this whole gambling thing with the cowboy hat guy from earlier.
Cowboy hat guy.
And someone suggested that me, Aunt, Jimmy, and maybe Patrice, a few other guys, would play a little blackjack. And we play the way you want to play.
I'll wipe the fucking floor with you.
And see if Anthony's, if his theory is right or not.
But it'll affect me. So you won't be able to get an accurate depiction of me playing blackjack because you guys playing like shit will affect me.
Where's the cards?
I don't know.
I'll fucking maul everybody.
Then we need a dealer. We need chips.
I'll get her to deal.
All right, so we're going to, but let's, we got to play for, you know, wink, wink, fake money.
Fake money?
Wink, wink. Nudge,
right
nudge.
No gambling on the air, huh?
What? We're not gambling. We're playing for fake money. I'll fucking wake everybody up.
We'll play for fake money.
Yeah.
You know, keep it all, whatever. Mm. All right, so anyway, Juno. So here, there's a lot going on. So the Carpenters sang this originally. You might recognize this song. Here it is. Just your iPod by the end of the day.
This is great.
Well, this the original's good, but wait till you hear what Sonic Youth did.
I've never heard this.
Nice. She did have a very good voice.
She sure did. There was no food going down there to fuck anything up.
No.
Just water and old fucking...
The vomit cleansed the vocal cords.
Yes. The fucking...
The acid.
The brown back of the teeth from the fucking stomach bile.
Here's the hook.
Fucking awful breath. Wow. That's the wind going through her ears.
All right.
That's good enough. So that's the original on the Juno soundtrack.
Walking trombone.
She's singing with her face in the toilet. That's why she has that nice echo. Those are fucking lyrics bouncing off the water before puke comes out. Fucking.
So, they're a hearty meal of a carrot stick.
Exactly. Oh, I'm going to treat myself. I'm going to have a garbanzo bean.
Garbanzo.
Microphone shaped like an index finger.
Did you run, like, blah!
So the soundtrack, which is...
Oh, old smelly knuckles.
Which is, which is... Jesus.
Oh, smelly knuckles.
Oh, shit. Oh, God.
So the soundtrack, which is interesting. Getting a little buzz right there, rolling the soundtrack.
Yeah.
It's not for everybody, though. It's a little indie, a little wimpy. But they have this song on there, same song you just heard done by Sonic Youth. Listen to the difference in the song.
Isn't it wild?
I will say, though, I enjoy the version by Miss Eat a Pack of Sir Today. I enjoyed her version a little bit better.
Fuck that fucking song.
Pack of Sir.
You didn't like the original, though? That's
pretty... You're right?
Yeah.
Jesus. The original, right?
The original was better.
Yeah.
I agree. I like the original. Yeah.
What, you like the original song?
I did, yeah. It was nice, man.
What was their big hit?
Sonic Youth?
The Carpenters.
Oh, everything. Shit.
They had a fuckload,
they
right?
They were the
Rainy
Beatles,
Days and
man.
Monday always. Yeah, yeah.
I can't think Give of one of their songs.
Oh, they
I'll tell you
they
which one.
What was like
ten,
their
ten,
number
ten,
one fucking...
Ten that, I bet you they had 10 songs that you know every
easily.
Word to.
Hey, yeah. Really? Let's go to Minnesota real fast. Mark, go ahead.
Hey, you know where you guys know that tune from?
What?
Did you want Tommy Boy? Remember when they're driving in the car
right.
and they both fall on their eyes?
Oh, right.
Man.
And they were just singing at the top of her lungs.
When did she
and
die?
Remake sounds like it belongs in Silence of the Lambs.
I would say 80.
Absolutely.
82.
So she just rotted away?
I'll say that. I don't know when. Fan?
Oh. Yeah.
I'm guessing 1982.
That she died?
Yeah.
I bet you it was in the 70s.
I don't think she made it to the 80s, bro.
Yeah, I don't think she did.
Well, she just...
Well, years active. 65 to 83.
Wow.
Uh-huh. No, and she died 32 years old in 1983.
Oh, wow. See, I was close.
32.
God almighty.
We got a list of their songs.
Do you have a picture of her when she was all skinny and shit?
Yeah, it's...
I don't know what she looked like.
It's not good.
I'm sure it's not. I gotta see it.
So,
No.
I'm trying to find, all right, whatever. Let's say hi to Bill in Ohio. Bill.
Yes, sir. How you doing?
Hey.
Hello, Bill.
Hey, what's going on, man? Honestly, you guys, seriously, I got to tell you something. I mean, I don't laugh at any shit, but I got to tell you something. You guys get on the radio. And you guys get on this thing. I just turned it on, man. And I heard you guys talk, and I couldn't fucking believe it. But I tell you what, I swear to God.
The last part of his call was actually my favorite.
I got the singles.
He should have just played the dial tones with the whole one. I would have enjoyed. Oh, wait, you hung up on him?
Yeah.
Oh, I thought he hung up. I'm sorry, sir. Thank you.
Rainy Days and Mondays, of course. Superstar, which you just heard. Top of the World.
I'm on top of the world, looking down on creation, and the
That's
only
three.
Explanation
I
can
heard.
Find
I don't know
is
one.
The love
yeah, you know
that I've found ever since
oh, no.
you've been around.
What's she saying? I'm standing on the top of a pile of mashed potatoes, and I'm falling in.
And not even sinking in, right. Very good, Jimmy. Well, here's the song, the one we're all trying to remember.
Is this it?
No. Close to You.
Oh, right.
That's the big Carpenter
Close
song.
To Wait, you.
I think this was the one that...
Could we hear it?
Yeah. Let's hear a little bit of that.
Who is she singing it to? A feather?
The Grim Reaper. This is the one I think that
I've heard this.
This is the biggie.
Are we fucking discussing the Carpenters on a Shock Jock radio show?
Oh, yeah, John Valley.
Vultures.
That's fucking hilarious.
Oh, that's funny.
Thirty-two, man, that's sad.
Thank you. Oh wow. Ew.
Oh,
she looks really fat on the right.
She looks really fat. What do we got here? Before and after? Oh, come on. No way. That's stretched.
What a puppet face.
After is looks, it? After looks like she opened a lost art.
Fuck, his face was melting there.
Wow.
Oh, big teeth.
How you doing? Get in the coffin.
That's what she looks like.
Go fuck yourself.
It's fucking George with a big wig on.
Suck that cock.
Oh, wow.
Can you please turn that up? I want to enjoy the song.
Thank you.
Please let Goldblum comment. Please let Jeff comment one more time.
Try a line. No, he's gay. I double him on an egg. Oh, fall down.
Close to you.
Shut your goddamn pie hole.
Detective John Kimball. I'm a twig, you idiot.
Now choke yourself. Don't pull my fucking hand over there. I said choke yourself. What's your name, fat body? Oh, you are a disgusting fat body, Private Pyle. Oh, you little maggot. You make me want to vomit. Who is that, Private Pyle?
Sir, jelly donuts, sir.
Can I tell you that fucking Goldblum, so any time a woman's clip is played, goddamn rich cunt will fucking tickle that. Me pink.
Goddamn rich cunt! I kill rich cunts!
That will make me laugh. Well, like when they play Hillary audio and that.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, God.
Fucking Goldblum.
Goddamn rich cunt.
One of his best lines ever.
That could be the best line ever said in the movie.
What is that? What's that from?
Death Wish. He was the original Death Wish. Beating it with a blackjack.
Wearing a Jughead cap.
Yeah.
Oh, Jeff Goldblum, one of the thugs.
Yeah.
He said that in the movie?
Goddamn rich cunt. We played that to him.
Goddamn rich cunt. I kill rich cunt.
When he called
and
in, he
killed her. Yeah.
He certainly did. Man of his word.
Oh, this poor woman. I didn't realize this woman was this... God damn.
What?
The Carpenter lady.
Oh, she always looks surprised.
Always looks surprised.
Oh my God.
She lost so much weight she couldn't close her eyes anymore.
Oh, Jesus, it's so sad.
That's really.
Oh my
awful.
God, man.
What were people telling her? You look good?
Yeah, probably.
Looks like you dropped everything.
Well.
They did all those behind the music.
They dropped everything.
Yeah. They should have just kept her in a bottle of like formaldehyde. It looked like somebody should have just smacked her with a pillowcase full of lye. Just rolling some dough and just look at poor woman. Just poor woman. Made it all those hit songs, man.
Great voice and everything, and then just decided I'm going to stop eating.
I'm just going to stop eating.
What did she die of technically, though? Like what?
Anorexia.
Anorexia, dude.
Whatever organ failure from that, but.
That's a horrible disease, I guess. I can't comprehend it.
It's one of these stupid, like,
who said that, Carlin? Can you give it to Bob Kelly?
It has the opposite.
Yeah.
Well, like, we remember George Carlin's bit, anorexia. He's like,
yeah.
He's like, what? Some rich cut don't want to eat?
Yeah.
Fuck her. What an American disease.
I don't want to eat. What the fuck is that, a disease?
Well, show me that disease anywhere else, especially in a third world country where they're fucking starving.
I think he did that actually at Comic Relief.
You didn't see that?
There's no African carpenter.
No. Some fucking Somali girl. She's fucking 15 years old. Her clit's been fucking taken out with a spade shovel.
The only carpenters are ants. Uses a punishment. You steal something, they put ants and honey on you. All cultures are the same.
And birds don't suddenly appear. They know they're going to be eaten. Birds are suddenly hunted. And if you get too close to me, my eyes are going to start bleeding from that Ebola. Oh, my God.
She looks like fucking Bobby from Taxi. Old Jeff Conaway face. I don't like her big teeth.
She looks like Adrian Barbeau and Max von Sydow.
Adrian Barbeau. Hey,
Jimmy, did Karen Carpenter like anorexia?
Karen Carpenter
loved it.
Loved it.
She didn't like throwing up while they were yelling, 2 minutes, Miss Carpenter.
She loved it. 2 minutes, Miss Carpenter. As her fucking hands fell off playing the drums.
The show's about to start.
I'm with you.
She used to play those drums.
She'd walk out and her feet would sound like the fucking velociraptors on the fucking tick. Shitty bones feet.
I'm on the floor of my closet. I can't do this line
She played the drums until she got too weak, and then she was just used as a drumstick.
She would throw herself on the drums.
Just scrape her face across the top of it.
What do we got? Go down a little bit and read Bill from Maine sung to On Top of the World. I'm just going to mess it up trying it. So,
oops. Let's see. I hit that accidentally. He didn't write it in a good context.
What was he shoehorning?
In good form, yeah.
He was shoehorning.
Shoehorning.
He had a good idea.
Just shoehorned fucking lyrics right on me, you prick.
He was reworking a Carpenter song, and it just all right.
Everything I want the world to blow.
Let's say hi to Mark in New England. Mark?
Yeah.
Is it snowing up there?
No, it's bright and sunny here, but...
what do you got?
You do realize that if Mama Cassidy shared her sandwich with Karen Carpenter, they'd both be alive today.
Wow. When's Mike Douglas on? Is that tonight?
Yes.
What the fuck are you doing? A Mama Cass, Karen Carpenter share food joke.
And I think Johnny is interviewing Dolly Parton.
Yeah, that new up and coming singer. Yeah. What the fuck's wrong with you?
I don't know. He's awful.
It wasn't an open invite to make fucking Mama Cass Elliot jokes. Let's go to Bob in Ohio.
Fucking asshole. What the fuck do they not know?
What were you thinking?
This is what I'm saying. How could they ever fire anybody on radio? As We're trying to be funny right away. He sat there and sat there. He could have got his timing right. Everything. And yeah, he came with that. Now, Mama Cass and Shad.
Share that sandwich. They both be alive.
What the fuck would does they, that even I mean?
Know. You turned a joke into a fact.
You fucking asshole. God damn it.
Liddy Rules from Whackbag writes, Karen wrote Top of the World after holding one balloon and floating to the sky.
Oh, my gosh.
Bob in Ohio. Bob. Bob.
No, it's Tom.
Hey, Tom. How are you?
Good. How you doing, guys? Good.
All right, man.
Creepier than Sonic Youth singing Superstar, Stalker Patty singing it to Oak.
Ooh. Yeah, maybe we should have Starker Patty. Maybe we should have a bunch of guys sing some Carpenter songs. Make the Carpenters Starker popular again.
Starker Patty would probably be the best bet, though.
All right, Tom. Thank you.
Thank you, Tom. Get home safe. Thank you for repeating it.
Get home safe.
Thank you. All right. Maybe we didn't hear it. And Obi was trying to be nice to the fucking ass. I go, yeah, that would be good. No one would, you piece of shit.
All right, well, Chris M. from Oklahoma City. I'm on top of the bowl looking down on my dinner. No? Fred from Brooklyn adding that her brother was a drug addict. Yeah, they had all sorts of shit going on in that family.
Oh, God.
Were the Carpenters all a family?
Yeah.
Oh,
brother-sister combo.
Platter. Yeah.
How many were there?
Just two of them.
That's it?
Yeah.
And a brother.
Well, that was it.
Who was in construction.
Her other brother was the Carpenter.
We're in silly mode.
Oh, God.
Yeah, brother Stan.
Stan Carpenter?
Yeah, Stan Carpenter. Worked for Home Depot.
Right. Custom installations of toilets and other things you will need if your sister can't stop throwing up and ruining the family fortune.
Yeah, that was like his whole fucking meal ticket there,
exactly. Wrong
so
term.
To speak. But you'd think he'd be shoving food down
his
throat.
His wasted meal ticket. I'm sure he tried to. He probably tried to slip her a grain of rice.
Looks like a snake eating something. See it in her neck.
What would she eat?
Apparently nothing.
Nothing at all? Mm. Didn't she have bad breath?
I think they eat, but then they throw up if you're bulimic. And then anorexia.
Yeah, yeah.
Anorexia, you just don't eat.
Ugh. Yeah. What do you do all day? Just chew gum?
Nothing.
Smoke? Yeah, what does she sit there and fart under an afghan?
What does she do? Because when we're bored, we eat, right?
Exactly. What would she do when she was bored? Chew socks?
Eats her dreams.
She just sleeps and eats dreams.
God, what happens that she doesn't want to eat? It's like the oddest thing. She's got, you know, great career.
That's that thing, man.
By the way, it gets more tragic. Karen Carpenter technically died of a heart attack due to her chronic use of syrup of... How do you say that word? I-P-E-C-A-C? I can never say that
word. Ipecac.
All right, Ipecac. That she was drinking to force herself to vomit.
Ugh, what a fucking annoying bitch. Have some Ipecac fucking juice.
Is that her?
83 pounds in 1977. What an ass.
In 77? 83 pounds? All right, another fucking...
Oh, Nicole Richie's only 82 pounds. Wow.
Hey.
I really cannot stomach these...
Well, Nicole Richie doesn't look like that anymore. She just had a kid.
Yeah, this old. But she got down to Karen Carpenter size. Wow.
74. She's not yet become severely ill. Yeah, look. Oh, she was all fat.
What, in 77, that was fat for her? 83 pounds?
Damn, she was 24. She was 27 when she was that skinny.
Yeah.
What a fucking... Why don't we just start calling fucking these chicks what they are, which is irritating? Why don't we stop painting it like it's a tragedy?
Yeah. Fucking eat.
Exactly. It's sad if
you eating death is just sad. That bothers me.
A disease? It's fucking eat. You've fixed your disease.
Yeah.
It's like someone's like that from cancer or something.
Doc, something's wrong with me. What's wrong? I feel light. I feel skinny.
Yeah, I'm weak.
He hands her a burger, take two, and call me in the morning. Asshole.
Guys, we got to go to San Francisco and say hi to Michael. Michael, you're on the Opie and Anthony show.
How you guys doing?
Thanks, Mike. All welcome right. aboard.
What do you got?
You know, if Mama Cass had shared a sandwich with Karen Carpenter, they could both be alive.
Wow.
All right.
Thanks.
All right.
You know, if you'd have shared your blood with Look. Robert Reed, we wouldn't have had to hear that.
Michael, where did you hear that?
Right, Jimmy.
Where did you hear that joke?
Where did I hear that joke? That's an old joke.
Is it?
It's like my father told it to me.
Really?
Possibly.
I never heard that. Who's Mama Cass?
Oh, Mama Cass, she died. She was
Shut the fuck up. Of course we know who she is. Jesus Christ, if you listen to the show for 10 minutes, you'd have known that already.
Let's go to Howard in Louisiana. Howard?
Fucking people.
Hey, what's going on, guys?
Hey.
What do you call Karen Carpenter with a yeast infection?
Oh, no. Hold on, let me think.
Here we go. Here.
A yeaster puker. No. Let me guess.
What do you mean guess?
Karen Carpenter with a yeast infection. 74 pounds of bread. No?
No.
What, sir?
A quarter
I don't
pound
care.
Of
cheese.
Oh.
All right. You know what?
She weighed a quarter pound.
Oh, wow. That's pretty.
Listen.
That's gross.
They call her a royale with cheese.
A royale.
Speaking of weight shit.
Yeah.
Our biggest gainer contest. Aren't we supposed to weigh everybody today?
Yeah.
Oh.
We got a biggest gainer contest happening on the Opie and Anthony show. What do we got? We got Butcher. We got who else? We got
Bronx. We got Butcher. We got Bronx Johnny. We got Travis and Lil.
And
young Lil.
Lil. I like calling her
right.
Lil with a little apostrophe, or the comma. No, it's an apostrophe. Oh, and then Lil.
Where's Lily?
We have neither Bronx Johnny nor Lily.
Where the fuck are they?
Did they get fired too? What the hell is going on over there?
Yeah, I think that. No, Lily isn't coming in until tomorrow.
Why?
All right, so we'll weigh him tomorrow.
What is Lily doing?
We'll weigh tomorrow. Fuck it.
It's her business.
How about we weigh tomorrow?
It's her business.
Put on the toilet.
Steve, make sure this happens. Get the Ron and Fez, you know, they're a bit lazy on this show, but tell them to come to work early so they can be weighed.
Well, they were supposed to, and then we found out today that neither one of them showed up because one of them was sick and the
Who's
other one
was sick.
Johnny.
What's wrong with Johnny's, right?
Some
AIDS.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
Really?
It's going to really hurt him in the contest.
Yeah, really. He'll
be eating and eating.
We don't want to start
losing weight.
We don't want to start unnecessary rumors on this show.
Can't gain much weight on AIDS. Broth.
Boss Johnny's really sick, though, huh?
Yeah. It's bad. Let's say hi to Walt the trucker. Walt.
Hey. I just got a comment on Mama Cass. The reason she started making herself sick, the anorexic, is because a reporter said that she looked fat on stage one day.
Karen Carpenter, right?
Yeah, that's what gave her the disease. Yeah.
Well, you know what?
Yeah. Good. I wish I was the reporter. How great that would feel. Chronicle of weight loss. Oh, go ahead, sir. That was my fault. I actually just jumped all over you with weak attempt at a joke.
Line of the day is brought to you by our good friends at
Bodog.
No.
Oh, at
it's right there in huge freaking letters. SkiColoradoNow.com.
SkiColoradoNow.com.
For info on great deals on 26 world-class resorts and up-to-the-minute snow conditions, log on to SkiColoradoNow.com.
Yay!
We have a runner-up line of the day. Go.
Like in boring, like regular guy talk. Like, all right, I'm going to do this right now. And he was just like talking like we're talking right now. And it was nothing sexy about it.
Did he make a do commercial reads?
Did he wipe his mouth with his tie?
Oh, my God.
What is this about? Hold on. David in Canada. Yeah. He had some kind of, why are we making fun of... I don't know.
What's up? Where's Dave?
He hung up.
Dave call back.
Because I was confused by your call.
Dave,
I was going
give a call
to you.
Back.
All right, here's another runner-up line of the day. Go ahead.
She's a big grass skirt cock.
She takes the Empire State Building right down to the sidewalk.
They got on.
Hi.
Quite the image.
Hello?
Hello?
Yes, sir.
That's Flea Man.
Oh, look.
Stupid
what?
Flea Man. Travis, what's up?
Hey, Gregorio, Antonio, Jimmy. Hey, I wanted to talk to Jimmy about...
You said my name wrong, sir.
You kind of did.
Jimmy.
I better get what's up.
Hey, I wanted to talk to you about your show in Minneapolis because I've tried to get tickets, and all that was left in December was shitty top balcony seats.
I honestly don't know, sir. I know that this show in Minneapolis is actually close to being sold out.
He either hung up or
weird. I've never been there.
He must have hung up because I didn't touch anything. Lewis in Texas, what's up?
Oh, hey guys. First of all, I just want to say I love you, love the show. But can you follow the bouncing ball of hypocrisy here?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Let us have it, sir.
You guys fucking ridicule women on a daily basis about their weight, and now you're bitching about them being too skinny.
Are you a faggot?
Yes, sir. What are you? What are you, fucking one of those people with respect
are
for
you
your wife?
Too skinny.
Oh, no, absolutely
Lewis,
not.
Lewis, what is wrong with you?
I'm
and I apologize to the faggots out there by calling Lewis one.
That's true.
Lewis, what's wrong with you? These are jokes.
Exactly.
What are you trying to say?
Huh? I'm just looking at fucking Chappelle on TV. It's Lou Gossett Chappelle.
Lewis, what are you trying to say?
I'm just saying that you probably hurt some feelings out there, and maybe guys are the cause of women's eating disorders.
You know what? We're kidding, man. You got to understand. We take it with a grain of salt, especially if that's all you eat.
Shit, your face. I love you guys.
Thank you.
There's a difference between asking your girl to lose a couple and anorexia, you dope.
That's right. I'd love an anorexic chick.
I don't have patience for anyone with anorexia.
Me neither.
Sorry, I just don't.
You won't have to. They'll die sooner or later.
If you don't want to eat, then don't eat.
You don't need much patience.
Not at all. Wait 20 minutes. Get him a satin pillow.
Bury you in a zigzag.
Jimmy, like, used to do a bit in his act about, like, OCD and stuff. And it's such a great bit where, you know, people back in our day when they had OCD and stuff, it was just called what? Don't do, you know.
You look like an asshole, yeah.
You look like an asshole, and you would just say, just stop doing that.
Just stop it, yeah.
But now there's names for everything. Everything. Here's another runner-up line of the day.
They have to duct tape socks to her hands so she doesn't scratch too hard. Because she's got such dry skin, she digs at the sores in her sleep.
How about gloves? Why socks on the hand?
Because they're poor.
Oh.
Because they're poor on top of it. Oops. How horrific is that?
It's awful.
Why not carry around in one of those puppy cases where her head sticks out?
And someone's calling us, you guys are just perfectionists. Damien from...
really?
Damien, you're a faithful. What's wrong with you today? Akron, Ohio, pissed off. Who doesn't enjoy a good Karen Carpenter beating every once in a while?
I live for them. Do you understand? If from 6 to 9:30 every day, she'd be attacking her. Without commercial breaks.
We should unbury her corpse and point and laugh at us.
That's right. We should raffle off chances to kick it.
Right.
For $10, we'll let you drop kick this skeleton who's actually in better shape than she was when she was alive. $10 and you can drop kick it.
She's shaped like an old miner's ghost. She's like the old man from Poltergeist. The guy that came knocking on the door.
God is in the holy temple.
Oh, all right. Damien's not pissed.
With that fucking stupid hat.
I don't understand your feeling. All right. What are we down to? One more runner-up? Here is the final runner-up line of the day for today.
Yeah, this fat bitch can sing.
Fat bitch. Fat bitch.
Do you realize, and this is what I love about the show, the humor on this show is fucking barbaric. It's fucking barbaric humor.
Brutal.
It is horrendous.
There's nothing nice about this.
Oh my, it's fucking vicious.
Horrid.
Hey,
old bitch.
I mean, that's great. Yeah.
Look like a bag full of antlers.
Let's go to
Karen Carpenter's nail. That's what her name should have been.
Let's go to Bloomsburg. This is Sean. What's up, Sean?
Good morning, Gregorio, Antonio, Jimmy.
No. If you can do it, you got to do it right.
I'm sorry. Well, hey, I just
no, wanted
to...
try it again. Try it again. Try it again, please.
Gregorio, Antonio, Jimmy, and Patricio.
No.
Nope, you missed Jimmy. Start over.
Gregorio.
All right, good.
Antonio.
Good.
Huh? Jimmy.
No.
No, everyone didn't know. No, no,
you got that wrong.
Just think Y-I-M-M-Y. Make it easy
and
for you.
And you got to put your hands together. Jimmy. The back of your... It's like this.
One more time. Gregorio, Antonio, Jimmy, and Patricio.
All right.
Okay. Hey, I learned on the...
Yeah, you learned, all right.
Oh, man.
He had a good line, too. Should have let him say it. SkiColoradoNow.com. Thanks for sponsoring Line of the Day. FTD, thanks for the flowers. Even though I chopped them up, sorry. But be, you know, smart next time. Two.
Yes.
Two bouquets.
We can't share that.
We can't share flowers. That's just weird.
Doesn't work.
PatriceO'Neill.com for his comedy dates. Right?
Yes, thank you.
How was the HBO thing?
What, Def Jam?
Yeah, was it good?
It aired last night and it's done.
Oh, you were on last night?
In like a lying out like a lamb. It's on and over.
Mm. Yeah, it'll be on a lot. HBO reruns shit a lot.
Yeah.
Mm. Are you happy with the set?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Well, the cut was, I don't know. Oh. Could have been better, but the set was good.
All right, here's your line of the day.
I enjoy it.
Here comes
Line of the Day. Line of the Day.
It's not going to take him home. I'm not taking him home.
Pinky's breath or something.
You've taken a lot of abuse lately. Cool. Let me...
Ferns, look at that.
Rex's awful head. It was like a Trojan horse.
Gregorio!
That was a good one, man.
That was a goodie.
A little mean-spirited. Poor kid.
All right.
Comes in, he tries to work.
Rex's head bugs me.
Oh, he's an incompetent bungler.
It gives his head is a physical reaction when you see it.
Yeah.
You just look at it and
your
you just
teeth
go,
clench.
You just want to just punch his head shape better.
Everything's fine from the waist down. He gets progressively worse, like starting at the toes. After the ankles on the way up, it's all shit.
If you didn't know E-Rock, you would swear he went to Hair Club for Men.
Yeah, and they nailed like his hair in like an inch apart.
No, he's got a full... He has too much hair, but it looks like a like it was fucking...
His hair is spaced like those triangles with those little golf tees in it. Remember like one of those little golf tees
yeah,
puzzles?
Yeah. You think there's a lot of space between his... I don't see that.
All Hawaiian punch hair.
I would kill for that much hair.
And his eyes are just set in too far. I don't like how far his eyes go back.
E-Rock, can you come in here for a sec?
His brain is right above his eyes.
Like a Doberman.
Let's point out what's wrong with E-Rock.
Can the anomaly
point
come in?
Out?
E-Rock. What are you saying, Patrice?
His face looks like 8 different comedians. Drew Carey, Bob Hope.
Drew Carey.
He got a Drew Carey's fat faceness. Bob Hope's nose. Howie Mandel's set-in eyebrows.
He says your eyes are too close.
It's just something. I think it's the hair. I think that's bugging me.
He's tried everything with him, man. I mean, I'll never, you know, knock you. You got a lot of hair, but it's just, I don't know.
You know, we're going way out. Way
out. Yeah, it's just. I was thinking cartoon myself. Like he's just shaped like a cartoon vulture. Like your neck starts under your chest.
It could also be like one of those Roman war helmets with like the fuzz on top. Yep. Yeah. You got that That's thing right. going. Victoria. Or the balls on your nose, whichever one you please.
Were you born bald or something? And they transplanted hair in there?
Nope.
How about you just shave the whole thing?
Would you do that? Pointy nose?
Does he really have a pointy nose?
Are you serious?
He can play records on the Flintstones. Enough of your nose. I have to fucking rub it on a stone and cut my steak with it. Fucking needle nose, I don't trust you. Fucking stinger. Leave Archie comic book face alone.
Yeah.
Oh, shit. And he just kind of has to stand there, huh?
Yeah.
Take I'm it. Just teasing. He
leave, leave first lesbian face.
Roland, you got anything? You good? I'm good. Everyone's good. All right, E-Rock.
We didn't mean it.
We'll end with, we're going to play the whole song, Sonic Youth, that started this mess of a last break. Sonic Youth doing the Carpenters' Superstar. We'll see you guys tomorrow.